for your dreams. I've been everything you wanna be. Oh, I'm the cult of personality. Like Mussolini and Kennedy.
Good Tuesday afternoon to you. You have found the voice of Ocala on a lovely Tuesday afternoon in the great city of Ocala. Sun is high in the sky, temperature rising. Buddy Martin joining us very soon. He's been hanging out with Chris Collinsworth, former Florida great and broadcaster with NBC. Buddy's been hanging out with Chris Collinsworth. They said Chris Collinsworth had some great things to say about being a dad. Buddy will tell us about those with his experience. It is Trivia Nator Tuesday with Tom. Coming up in the next segment, we'll get you all started with Trivia Nator Tuesday. Your chance to win two tickets to the historic Marion Theater. Also, Buddy's going to tell you about something that happened 30 years ago today. Famous time in history. 30 years ago today. We're not going to forget tweets and quotes, but it is the ever-popular Around the Water Cooler today as well in the 5 o'clock hour. Tom James joins the crew that includes J.J. LaSalva, myself, and Buddy Martin. We even may get Sean Down Goes Frazier involved for Around the Water Cooler, where we talk about the hottest topic in sports. With that, I welcome in J.J. LaSalva. J.J., how's your day going?
It's good. It's hot.
It is hot out there. You usually come in to the studio and you got on like a little overcoat, like a light jacket or some sort of sweatshirt, because it's usually cold in here.
I never wear a jacket or a light sweater in here.
Well, what is, you know, the like,
I've never worn that since maybe December, January.
You always think it's cold in the studio, correct?
Saturday mornings is the only day it's cold in the studio. We have something that goes on in the Cascades on Saturday mornings where they turn the air down for some reason.
All right, well, JJ's going to help me with my radio show here soon. I don't know when it'll be, but he'll help soon, I'm sure. So anyway, let's get right into what's going on today. Another man has an airplane, has to turn around on the turnaround. He's aboard a flight from Hong Kong. Man jumped up, began ranting about national security and the CIA. He was tackled, bound by hand and feet, and the passenger sat on him and kept him down for 6 hours. It's getting where crazy things are happening in airplanes, and I don't understand. Once you're in an airplane, you know you're going to be there. If you're flying from Hong Kong, you know you're going to be there for 6 to 8 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours. I'm not real sure how long the flight is. But if you're going to be up there, you're in a closed-in area. They got marshals on these planes now and everything. Nothing good. You're not going to win that argument on a plane when you start freaking out. After 9/11, anytime somebody becomes boisterous or tries to force their will on other people, you're going to be dealt with on an airplane. And you see these stories 5 or 6 times a year, and I just don't... I mean, I guess the guy was unstable or something. I don't understand.
Yo.
Wow. Daniel Owen just shows up out of the blue here in the studio. You want to sit down and get on the radio? Buddy will be here soon.
Like an hour, Buddy will not be here.
Buddy Martin, Daniel Owen has just walked in the studio wanting to know where you are. So he may need some golf tips. We're joined by the straw, Daniel Owen. Long time no see, sir. How have you been? You're trying to get Buddy's headphones on. Good luck with that. How you been? Good to see you. You got to adjust this over here somehow.
No, I'm doing good, Tom. Appreciate you letting me stop in.
You got some big news for us?
I do have some big news, and I wanted to give it to y'all before I gave it the Star Banner. I do, believe it or not, have an allegiance to the show and Buddy Martin and everything else. So how are things going, man?
Good, good. You know, Trivia Nator Tuesday with Tom. You're not allowed to play, though. You know all the answers. So
thank God for Google. In this day and time, we're all experts, aren't
well,
we?
Well, you know, the beauty of it is that's why we ask two questions. They always get the first question and then the second question. They're like, that's not fair. I was like, the fact that you can't type fast enough is not fair. You're entirely correct.
I'm telling you, how's Buddy doing? How's everything
Buddy's going? Doing well. He's doing well, every Tuesday now. Tuesday's... He takes an extra hour on Tuesdays to get his stuff together and everything. Today was with, you know, hobnobbing with Chris Collinsworth. He was big time with Chris Collinsworth.
Oh, Lord. Well, yeah, that means that probably Brantley wasn't too far behind.
Oh, I guarantee you the mouth of the South was there somewhere.
Gosh.
being it was a Trinity football event.
JJ, how's everything going, man?
Straight. You know, we've missed you, man.
Go Spurs, yeah.
Go Spurs. There's
are
a jab.
Are you a Spurs fan?
He just dislikes Miami, I think.
No. Listen, I did want to stop by. I appreciate the time you let me drop in. I'm getting ready to head to council. I've got to be at City Hall in about the... I don't know. I got to be there in about 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Like I said, I did want to give you all, not that it's a big story or too much breaking news, but tonight at council, I'm going to be announcing that I will not be seeking a fourth term as City Council District 5.
Wow, that's huge news.
For some, I'm telling you, people just ran off the road with excitement, man. There's dancing in the street.
So Daniel Owen, you heard it here first, folks. Daniel Owen has said he will not be seeking re-election for District 5, for Seat 5.
But, correct. You know, 2016, President of the United States,
yeah.
Always out there.
Exactly. It's always out there. No, but it's been 12 years, Tom. My son was 4 years old the week that I got sworn in.
I see your son now.
Last public meeting coming in December, he will be 16.
I see your son often. He's not four anymore.
No, he's not four. But it's been great. I've enjoyed it. I've loved it. But I wanted to stop by. I know, Buddy, if y'all had got up in the morning and read that in
Buddy
the Star banner.
Buddy is jumping around right now.
He's joining the masses with, thank God he's finally leaving.
Buddy, so then are you announcing you're running for mayor? Is that what you're doing?
No,
the last guy that stepped down after 12 years became mayor.
You know, I just don't look as good as Kent Gwynn. I mean, it
just
is impossible.
Nice.
I don't dress as nice. We'd shop in completely different places. I think I bought a pair of socks one time at Griner's. Kent, you know, buys his toothpaste there.
Yeah. So what you're saying is the mayor's position is not an Old Navy type place.
No, it is not. It's not. We couldn't be mayor. I mean, no. Gene, you know, us big guys, we got to have room to move. So jeans and a T-shirt is where it's at.
Could not
tie. Where's the last time you had a tie on?
Lincoln Reagan Day dinner.
Nice. Went hurt governor, did you?
I was the MC of the event. I actually
look at you.
I actually had the governor on one side and Jeff Atwater, the CFO, on the other side.
Check you out.
I had one of those penguin suits on. Believe me, Jim Falvey got it for me at Falvey's Men's Store.
Nice.
They were able to put a 22-inch tuxedo neck around me.
22-inch.
Yeah.
I'm not too far behind you, brother.
No, but it was a good time. Sue Mosley talked me into that. So,
what does it say when your neck is a higher number than your sleeve number?
What happened is I should have been a church's chicken snack pack because I was born with three thighs. That's what happened there.
I thought this was a family show, Tom.
That's what happened there. You got a neck 20. I got a neck as big as one of my thighs. Yeah. You know,
you're going to Griner's, so you got any 22, 21s?
I just like messing with people. I'll walk in and say, do you have a 23-inch neck with a 32-inch sleeve?
Buddy said he's coming in, by the way.
Buddy's on his way in, look.
It's like trying to put a cardigan on a T-Rex.
It's just not going to happen. You know why a T-Rex doesn't fit a cardigan? Why a cardigan doesn't fit a T-Rex, though? Arms are too long.
Exactly. No, so, but hopefully everything's well. I don't mean to crash the show.
Any other plans?
Right now, no. It has just been 12 years of enjoyment of public service. A lot's been accomplished, I think. But time comes. You know, there's just time for fresh voices. I think 12 years, Tom, we start talking about career politicians and everything else. Of course, our compensation package at the city is so overwhelming. I mean, it is going to be it's going to be hard. You know,
to step down from that.
My checkbook's going to take a hit with not getting that $200 a month anymore.
So you're going to take – that's going to be a $2,400 a year hit.
It's huge, man. I mean, you just it's down.
$2,400. It may drop you in a tax bracket.
And I know. Who knows? It's going to help with my Obamacare come January.
Now, you don't get a lifetime pension like all the politicians in Washington?
Let me tell you something. I'll be lucky to get a garden of chocolate bar or something from the state. No charter government. There is no pension. There's no retirement. There's no nothing.
Well, let me ask you this. In your 12 years of service,
yes.
It'll come to an end in December. We're sorry to see you go, by the way.
Well,
I enjoyed going to City Hall, to city meetings at City Hall.
Try to liven things up, you know.
Between you and Jimmy Gooding, if either one of you aren't there, there'll be no reason to go. No offense, John McLeod, Jay Musley, Mary Sue, Susie Heimbuckle, but without Daniel and Jimmy Gooding there, there'd be no reason for me to go. I live in the county. I like going just to watch the show. So, in your 12 years of service,
yep.
Can you give me on the cuff right now what you're most proud of?
that economic development is now the cool thing to do from an elected standpoint. I can tell you, Tom, that there are, as we know, minutes of meetings and there are votes that have been cast, say, 10 years ago, just as little as 10 years ago, where economic development was non-existent. And I know there may be somebody out there to get upset at this. Economic development was non-existent at the county level. I mean, they just recently, in the last couple of years, have formed an economic development. And they're doing it. They're starting to realize, and they're starting to get
they're going gangbusters
that maybe you need to build a road if FedEx wants to get here. And maybe you need to have an industrial park, you know, because we had horse farms. And I remember I go back to the days of Cisco, and I told the gentleman who was in charge of real estate for Cisco, I said, send a letter to the city requesting that you're going to buy Pine Oaks. And the political fallout over that was huge because we didn't have any place. There was nowhere to put them but a golf course, and there was nowhere to put the Walmart but horse farms. And so as we sit here, you know, and start to see we have industrial parks, we've got Magna property, we've got the airport, we've got places now to stick some of these big boxes, and it's a cool thing. So you hear it coming this campaign season, and you're going to always hear it. You'll hear it next year at the county level. You know, I believe in jobs, and you know, you hear all of this stuff. So now it's a cool thing to do, and so it's been exciting to see that turn. I look at IHMC, I look at the downtown, Dr. Ford, the addition of what's going on in the downtown Ocala. I'll talk about it a lot with Buddy, but it's huge. What's going on there? So there's a few little feathers in the cap, but hey.
Well, real quick, what's your least favorite thing that's happened in the 12 years since you've been there?
Well, I know with the announcement tonight that I will be going into the lame Muscovy status.
Right. That. Don't even get me started on those ducks. I was at the golf course this weekend. Don't even get me started on those ducks, okay?
Some people go lame duck. I go lame Muscovy.
What's your but out of the 12, the duck situation probably.
Well,
be
you know,
favorite.
It probably could have handled a little bit better, but for God's sakes, they're nasty. What do you want to do? Got to try to clean the
and
parts.
And if it's supposed to be the central park of Ocala,
I know. The you last don't thing. Want, you don't they're want cannibals. They're cannibals, for God's sake.
And
sakes.
They don't leave a good sitting area on the park benches. Let's just leave it at that.
Exactly. It's not exactly. You don't want to go down there and throw your meatball sub with extra Parmesan down on the table from Subway and
they're
say.
They're about as good about where they.
Life is good.
They're about. They're, Muscovy ducks are as good about where they, you know, leave parts of themselves as a seagull is, and that ain't real good.
Exactly. You know, you just fly and swim, and who cares about the rest?
Exactly. So you're proud of the economic development. Everybody's finally getting it on the same page. You're least proud about how the duck situation went off. Are you 10 years from now, where do you hope your legacy stands with the 12 years you served on council?
I mean that's from the bottom of my heart. It doesn't matter. You know, there's things that if what we won't know until 10 years from now. Some of the decisions that get made, sometimes it just takes time for them to sort of marinate, right? And especially in government, you don't know. We got to look at things and see how they're going. I like where we're at. I still think Ocala needs to be the economic hub of Marion County. We're going to continue to hopefully push that. Our population's getting smaller and smaller by U.S. Census. And by 2025, it's funny that you bring up the next 10 years. The next 10 years, Tom, the city of Ocala proper will be less than 5% of the population of Marion County. So you think about that at 50 to 60,000 people. So we're going to hit 500,000. We're going to maybe hit 600,000 people in this county. And Ocala's going to be this little, you know, gnat on a cow's butt.
It's going to be like Zuber, practically.
I really?
I mean, literally.
Zuber with a courthouse.
That's where I live,
right?
Is Zuber.
I mean, we're going to be Zuber with a courthouse.
Exactly.
And so we got to matter. And that's why it's been economic development for me and seeing to it that Ocala matters. Some people don't believe that, but it's happening right in front of us. I mean, look at the phenomenon of the villages. You know, I mean, they're a whole, you know, in 1990, the villages was called Orange Blossom Gardens, and it was a trailer park with a bunch of double wides, and now it's a zip code. I mean, it is a zip code. It's huge. So,
well, Daniel, we thank you for stopping by. I know you got to get to council. We got to take
a
break.
I know you got to take a break. I've crashed the show. Buddy's not here.
No, Buddy's on his way. He said not to go anywhere.
Buddy said don't go anywhere. So you have
Buddy's running around.
Yeah. So.
Well, he's gonna have to get back in the car and get back up here. He's out on the streets dancing with everybody.
We're gonna take a break. When we come back, more on the breaking news of Daniel Owen not seeking re-election after 12 years of service to the city of Ocala on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com, The Source.
Since 1976, Daniel L. Hightower, a lawyer, has been fighting for accident victim justice in North Central Florida and statewide. He believes everyone in America should follow the rules, including the insurance companies. He and his firm have experience fighting for victims of personal injury, wrongful death, workers' compensation, and Social Security disability, as well as serving those in need of help with bankruptcy, simple wills, and estate plans. The mission at the law offices of Daniel L. Hightower, PA, is to represent deserving clients and recover the maximum benefits they are entitled to by law in a timely manner. In personal injury and workers' compensation cases, there are no fees or costs unless a recovery is made. The law office of Daniel L. Hightower is located at 7 East Silver Springs Boulevard, Suite 300. For your free consultation, call 352-629-7777 or 1-888-LAW-1976 and visit danhightower.com for more information. Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice, and the proud sponsor of Ask the Cops.
This reprise of Ask the Cops is proudly brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
A couple weeks ago, I was involved in a minor car accident, and they said they were going to send out highway patrol. And I was wondering if this was like the new philosophy of the sheriff's department to keep the boots on the ground and keep our sheriffs out there trying to solve these crimes rather than these minor traffic accident.
Yes, ma'am, I totally agree with that. We don't investigate accidents, vehicle accidents in the county. So now we will respond if there's a traffic situation where we need someone there to take care of traffic until Florida Highway Patrol can respond. But we don't investigate traffic accidents. So, and if it's not serious in nature, then we probably just have the cars pull off to the side and then you would wait for Florida Highway Patrol to show up to work the case.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala, Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA, The Source.
WOCA, Ocala.
I'm heading down to Daytona, where it all begins.
Hear that? You could be going down to Daytona for the hottest races this summer.
Well, the track is really fast.
The Firecracker 250 on Friday, July 5th, and the Coke Zero 400 Saturday, July 6th.
They start the season even.
And all you have to do is register for your chance to win at the following location. Baseline Auto Sales, 2501 Southeast 58th Avenue on Baseline Road. Brick City Health and Fitness in the Pine Plaza on South Pine. And at the home games for the Ocala Stampede played at Trinity Catholic. Each sponsor will have two tickets for each race, and the drawings will be held Friday, June 28th. There's no obligation to enter, so you don't need to be present to win. And enter as often as you'd like. You're always a winner with WOCA The Source, and you could be... As you're driving down the road, you may love your car, you may hate it. But the fact remains that you've got to keep it running to get back and forth to where you need to go. WOCA The Source and Sunrise Automotive are here to help with that. For a limited time, if you mention WOCA, you will receive $10 off an oil change at Sunrise Automotive. That's right, not 10%, $10 off any oil change at Sunrise Automotive. Sunrise Automotive is an ASE-certified automotive repair center, so they know how to take care of your car. Located at 1800 Northwest 10th Street, all you have to do is call to schedule your oil change, 690-1993. Mention that you heard this ad on WOCA and get $10 off an oil change. It's just that easy. So now you have 10 more reasons to head down to Sunrise Automotive, 1800 Northwest 10th Street, Ocala. And don't forget to listen to Matt every Monday morning at 10 a.m. for auto repair with personal care. Right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source, your source for $10 off an oil change.
Are you looking
looking for a trustworthy auto care company that won't sell you something you don't need? Look no further than Affordable Auto Air and Care. Affordable Auto Air and Care has serviced Ocala for a decade and is family owned and operated. They offer quality parts at affordable prices, and they even include a 1 year or 12,000 mile warranty on their parts and labor. Their certified technicians work on any type of vehicle, even RVs. They specialize in auto AC, but they also offer oil changes, brake service, filters, tune-up, shocks, axles, complete auto repair. Affordable Auto Air and Care is located at 1841 Northwest 4th Avenue on the corner of Old Jacksonville Road and 441. Call 352-401-0011 to book an appointment. That's 352-401-0011. Affordable Auto Air and Care. Complete auto repair. Take it from me, Tom Schmitz. I'm a customer.
I get you up there where the air is rarefied. We'll just glide starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You will hear angels cheer because we're together.
Hello, how are you? I'm Buddy Martin. I just came in off of my afternoon on breaking news. I heard that Daniel Owens was running for U.S. Senate. And I wanted to say congratulations, and I want to go to Washington with you, okay?
All right, I appreciate it.
How are you, man?
He said you don't get here till 4 on Tuesdays. I said, see there, even when I leave, I make people mad. I made Buddy come in early.
Well, it was a little bit of a surprise to hear that news, and good to hear your voice. I just want to say that, in all seriousness, we joke around a lot, but you have been a big friend of this show, and I appreciate that. Back in the days, you were struggling, you know, to get on the air and get going, and I think you only had about 5 or 6 listeners. We're up to, like, we tripled that now. We're like 15, so we...
Well, there's at least 14 of them that just got a good afternoon with my news.
I don't know about that now, but tell me. I mean, I heard Tom's interview with you, and we apologize to those who are expecting trivia today.
I apologize for jumping in and crashing the show.
No, your life's not trivial. It didn't belong in this hour. But, I mean, I'm glad that you came here to tell us about the announcement. What's behind all this? Tell me the real scoop.
No, well, really, buddy, it's been 12 years. You know, there's been a lot going on. To run through another election, I'm going to have to commit again to another 4 years. It'll be 16 years. And my son, I think about, I was saying it, you probably heard it, the week I got sworn in, my first was 34 years old, and wow, I'm on city council, right? Riley was standing next to me. I got a picture. He's 4. This coming December, Riley will be 16. Driving out of the driveway. I know you've been through that of all of a sudden your little babies are now driving and they're gone, and it's just, wow, what happened? How fast that it goes, and it goes through. And so I thought about that, and I just, there's been, it's always easy to sit here and say, well, we got a lot accomplished or whatever, and there's always more to do. You sit here and think there's, as you know, but you talk about, you talk a lot about Ocala and Marion County, what a great place it is. There's always going to be great things to do to sort of drag this place over the finish line on a daily basis. And I think it's time. I'm at real peace about it. I think a lot of good things have been set, as I told Tom in the last segment. Promoting Ocala, Marion County now, at least from an economic hub standpoint, is a cool thing to do. And that's something I think, as I look and I've seen, because it just wasn't that way 10 years ago. People can say that it wasn't.
It wasn't that way 2 years ago, really.
It just wasn't, and now it is, and so it's exciting. And we've seen a lot of great things grow. There's a lot of good things in place, and I just feel that it's time. And, I'll be 46 September. I think it's going to open up some other opportunities for me. People, and when I challenged you, is what, 18 months ago, maybe 2 years ago now, on the Marion Theater, come down for a little bit of a little
council meeting. Ate me alive.
Hey, let's get these people doing something. Boom. Well, all of a sudden, you started living and breathing and the success, down to the nth degree of the Marion Theater. And it's the same way. It's no different than being on council. You live, you breathe, you everything you do. What are we going to do in Ocala today to make it better? And people, you know, I know it's politics. But, well, you know, you did this, and you always get emails. I mean, that's the nature of politics. You're going to have half the people love you, half the people hate you. That's the nature of it. But for those who are in it, and you really do, you really, it's a constant thing of what can we do a little bit better today? What can we, you know, what can we do? Can we try this? Can we do this? And what's going on? And it just comes time to where it's taxing, and it gets to be a lot. As I told Tom, our compensation package at the city, which I think is the purity of what makes Ocala work. Yeah. Quite honestly, yeah. As I always joke and say, people say, you know, you'll say anything in a public meeting. Well, they don't pay me enough to care, kind of deal. You know, at $200 a month. I've loved every second of it. I'm gonna continue to be here, not going anywhere. But it's just time to let somebody else get up there, have a fresh face, new voice. And, you know, you cross your fingers and you hold your heart and you hope some of the stuff that you started will continue. You know what? Ocala was here long before I got here, buddy, and it's going to continue to be here.
Well, buddy, you know what the problem is. It's that I figured it out. It has nothing to do with him wanting to step down from politics. It has nothing to do with he thinks the city's in a good place or anything.
Working on his golf game.
It's Steve Albright just won the Marion Masters for the fourth time and moved in front of Daniel, and so Daniel's got to get back in a tie.
Tied him,
no, no, he moved in front of him. Daniel's won at three.
I'm tired of that mess. I got to get back out there and start hitting golf balls.
That's the whole thing.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I'm happy for you that you've come to this place in your life where you feel like you know what you want to do. The thing that worries me, Tom, is that, you know, you saw the movie The Great Gatsby. I think of The Great Gadfly, which is what Daniel's always been, and we need that here. And well, I don't know of a bigger supporter, booster, backer, what you want to call it, of Ocala and Marion County anywhere than Daniel Owen. You may not like the way he says it sometimes, or how he goes about it, but he's always out there trying to tell everybody what a great place we have here and promoting this town. Promoting his counting and telling people that we can do it here. And I like that attitude. I'm really kind of a little bit sick of mamby-pamby politicians. I've said it on the air here. Of people get elected and go hide. You know, you can't get them.
Daniel will never be.
No, that's one thing.
He never hid.
I'm like the kid who plays hide and seek. You go and hide, but you never shut up. You keep running your mouth. So all you got to do is stand still. You'll find them. I try to run and hide. I just have too much fun running my mouth.
You're like the kid who puts his hand over his eyes and says, okay, find me.
Yeah, you can't see me.
But, you know, buddy, it's like you've told the story on this show numerous times. You knew he had a great affinity for the Ocala area. Just from telling the story of you and him two Christmases ago, mm-hmm. walking on the square, and that's where the whole concept of Feel Downtown really took place.
Yeah, well, he stopped me. I was across the street right there, right across from Harry, catty corner from Harry's, and said, stop, wait. He said, look at that. And, of course, the square was lit up with Christmas lights. He said, is that beautiful or what? How special? And it wasn't just a scene. It was a feeling at that point about how great this place can be when all things work together for good. And, that was an epiphany, I think, for both of us in that moment. And you're right, out of that came Feel Downtown, and I give Tito Comas his due for
absolutely
coming up with it, and Brendan Martin, but that was the idea,
was,
you know. And
they just, you know, yeah.
Tito's wife deserves some of that credit, too.
All of them. But fact is, we experienced that, and with Daniel. And, you know, I'm really kind of, I'm happy for you, but sad for us, because we need some hard-charging people to get us to the next level, Daniel.
Well, and that's the one thing where my hope and my prayer and my wish is that the fervor continues. Ocala's a great place. I was telling, again, Tom, you probably heard it coming in. I've said it. You know, Ocala's getting smaller, and people always have looked at me in a funny way when I've said that. But you know, in the next 10 to 15 years, Ocala is going to be less than 5% of the population of Marion County. And so why Ocala? What? And people say, well, you're never going to have a problem. Logistically, Ocala is always going to be the economic hub of Marion County. But I'm not so sure. I mean, you look at the villages. You look at On Top of the World. You look at growth patterns of where there's things going. It's like any other community that just expands and expands and expands, and it grows and it gets more urban out through there. And so why Ocala? You know, the question is, why Ocala? And thank God we've been able to circle the wagons on Magna. We got FedEx coming, so that's going to always be sort of that's going to be. But the FedEx is going to reap benefits for the next 30 years in the city of Ocala, and thank God it's in the city.
Needs to be a metro Ocala anyway. Really, basically, we need to become metro in that regard, and I think that's what we're all going. You pointed this out to me some time ago, and I hadn't thought of it about the tail wagging the dog.
Yep.
About all the power and money is going to be in the South County here soon. I brought this up to Stan McLean on this show several weeks ago, and he sort of acknowledged it. But the fact is, if you're not doing business, you know, down in South Marion, you know, and you got your eyes on this in county on any politics, yeah, you're going to miss out because that's where the powers come from. The money, as you pointed out to me, and you're exactly right. Yeah. Despite the fact that you joke a lot, you're a pretty good student of things like that.
I'm telling you, if you're going to be elected in the county, you get you a golf cart and go drive in the streets of the villages on top
and
of the
a
world.
Tractor and go to North Marion.
Yeah. And passing out Scotch and Viagra, and you'd get a chance to be listened to.
For those just driving by, saying a councilman, City Councilman Daniel Owen, dropped in. Of course, when I wasn't here, and that's the way it always is.
I thought you'd be here, but I wanted to give you. I said, you know what? I'm going to tell Buddy that when this comes up, he can say, you know what? It was on the air before it was in print.
I appreciate that, and probably by now people are calling you on your cell saying, where are you? They want to put you on ocala.com. But to announce that you're not going to run for a fifth term,
fourth
term. And that ends as of this next year?
December. The election in the city's going to be a city election in October. I think October 15th, I think, is
but
the day.
But not for your seat, is it?
Yes, my seat, Susie Heinbockel's seat.
Jay Musley's
seat. And Kent, does anybody know when Griner's opens? Gwen will be up for reelection coming October. And they take seat first meeting in December.
I have to ask these questions, although you can, if you can perfectly willing, if you want to say I'm not going to answer it. Tom did ask you one. Will you be back in politics again?
You know what? If the opportunity arises, I will run.
Okay. Meaning mayor? Meaning councilman? Meaning U.S. state senator? Meaning what?
I enjoy public service. The way the charter's set up in the city of Ocala, the mayor, and I'm sorry, Ken, if you're listening, and maybe you are, maybe you're not. It's fun to be mayor, no doubt. You're in charge of the police department.
Can't do very much.
You can't do anything.
It's called a tradition, textbooks, a weak mayor system.
Correct.
No offense to the mayor, but that's how it's built.
Yeah, we just have a weak mayor form of government. Mm-hmm. The city council is in charge, and 3-2 always are going to rule the roost. And I think it's great. And again, you know, we all get $200 a month. The mayor gets a little bit more. But I just enjoy trying to make my community a little bit better.
So you're not done in that regard.
I'm not done in that regard, and I don't know. Is there other seats out there that may be? There might be, and then again, this may have been it. I may have had my 12 years as a politician at the city council level, and we'll keep plugging on.
Have people spoken to you about the possibility of running against on some other office?
No, I mean, you get a few
other questions. Than just chit-chat.
You have a few questions here and then, you know. I mean, my son even. Dad, what do you want to do next? What do you want to do next kind of deal? Because he's enjoyed, you know, ride a fire mm-hmm. truck every year in the parade. So he's like, what are we doing next kind of deal? So,
hitting the golf ball, by the way.
Hitting the golf ball. He's hitting it really. He's hitting it a long way.
Riley's 16 now.
And he'll be 16 he'll be December. 16.
He's playing at
sophomore in Forest. Yep.
Playing on a golf team?
Playing on a golf team. Mm-hmm. They're going to have a pretty good little team this year.
Yeah, with the Lovell boys
Lovell's
on there.
And a couple other guys on there. They're going to have a strong little team.
I'm sorry that my grandnephew, Howie George, is not going back here to play. He's going to go play at Trinity. But
there's a couple of them moving over to Trinity.
Possible state championship team.
Absolutely.
With those guys in there. And so you're enrolled and you're involved in golf and being involved, helping get the refurbishing of the – look. Stay around for a minute. And when do you have to go? Can you say one more segment?
I've got the shade meeting.
We
got
to find out where you're going to do
it. 4:00. I got council meeting. Yeah, go ahead.
Without that $200 a month.
See there, they're already calling me. Where are you at?
All right, we'll do this. Let's keep him a couple more minutes and let him go because he got things to do. But I didn't want to miss out on your big announcement. And,
well, they don't need me at the 3:30 meeting since I told Tom I'm now a lame Muscovy, so they don't need me.
Speaking of lame Muscovies, real quick, we have to get a highlight reel here real quick. And I'll let Daniel go. But of the two or three things that you've done that are most memorable, certainly the ducks would be right up there, wouldn't it?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, that's just one of those things where, you know, again, my diplomacy left a lot to be desired. And we got people who were fighting for one animal and were ruining the whole parks, and I just, you know, I had a lapse of maturity.
But you had fun with it, and you came on this program and talked about it, and of course you put on the duck shirt afterwards and
Shut the duck up.
Yeah, exactly. All right, what else? Give me a couple more things highlights of your time there in the city.
I'll tell you what, as you know, when I look at Dr. Ford and IHMC and the thing, I'm telling you, buddy, you ought to at least have a once a month IHMC report to let people know what's going on one block off the square in downtown Ocala, and people would be amazed. When you see all of this stuff that's going on in the national news right now, this cyber attacks and what are we going to do for the Chinese and how are we going to control our red lights and our infrastructure and all these things, these cyber attacks, when you see this, I'm telling you, folks, in downtown Ocala, IHMC is combating ways in which to fend off cyber attacks from around the world. And the technology, four blocks down here, buddy, it's happening in Ocala, and I look at that and I think, what a great thing to have been a part of that and see that rooted in there now. And it's a fabric of the downtown. And Dr. Ford, you know, you've met him several times, and he loves being here. And to have been a part of that, I remember the time, for 2.5 years, Dr. Ford was driving around Ocala. He goes, I want to be here. And you know the story. He drove through here on his Harley, headed over to Bike Week, and said, I'm going to put a satellite office here. I want to be here for 2.5 years. So we couldn't. And the library kept sitting there empty. And I called him one day, and I said, when are you coming back? And he goes, I said, I want to show you a building. I went over to the city manager's office, and the city manager, who was two city managers ago, I said, I need the key to the library. I want to go show Dr. Ford something. And quite honestly, the city manager at the time said, well, we're not putting IHMC in there. I mean, we got other plans for that. That's going to be a parking garage. And I said, well, okay, well, that's fine. I said, anyways, give me the key. And I took the key, and I told Dr. Ford, I said, Dr. Ford, I'm not the mayor, so I can't give you a key to the city. I said, but I am on council. I can get you a key to the library. And we went in there, and, buddy, if you would have been at that time, it was just he and I walking through the building, a light bulb went off. And I took him downstairs, you know, the basement that is down there, and he went downstairs, and then his eyes got a little bit bigger. And we sit here today, and you know what happens down there. I mean, it happened. And
well, you deserve a lot of credit for that.
It's huge to be able to sit there and say what a fantastic way in which that worked out.
Yeah, so, I know two of the things will be, aside from your role in other projects, certainly one of them is going to be Silver Springs, which you've been way by. You've been boosting that forever, and your role in that. I know you've been really working hard behind the scenes, And hopefully it'll be baseball. You know, maybe that'll come about too. I know you're a big proponent of that, and so
we'll see.
Of a half cent. Yeah. Listen, Daniel, I want to thank you for number one coming by here, number two for being such a great friend of the show all these years.
Just think all the time I got now, buddy, to start.
Come on,
doing
we got
longer
seat over here. Come on,
I'll cover for you on Tuesdays. You cannot come in until 4:30.
Our city council. We go to our city council correspondent, Daniel Owen. What's going to happen in the city hall
today,
right,
Daniel? Buddy, sports hour.
Yeah,
you can not even come until 5 o'clock, buddy.
Yeah, and of course the golf beat, and then of course all the things that are going on in downtown. Daniel, congratulations. Good luck to you.
Appreciate it.
Keep us posted on what you got planned, and let's keep the great gadfly going. Okay,
we'll keep it, buddy, and appreciate it. And y'all have a good rest of the show. And I do appreciate you letting me stop in. But
anytime, you're welcome. You know that.
I wanted it to crack the airwaves of Ocala before it cracked the print.
All right, thank you so much. Councilman Daniel Owen says he will not run for a fourth term. You heard it right here on the Voice of Ocala. Appreciate Tom making a little room for us here on the Tribunator Hour, and we'll step aside here and let Tom finish up his business, and we'll come back, and we'll maybe do it for the next hour. Who knows? Whatever. It's always good to have breaking news, and thanks, Tom, for grabbing that one and running with it.
That's one of those. That's why it's good to be a newsman. When it falls in your lap, it's an easy job.
You got to be adjustable. You got to be flexible. All right, we'll take a break. Come back and more right here with the Tribunator, Tom. Coming up next right here on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com, the source.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin for Renstar Medical Research. Every day we hear another story about innovation or about the cutting edge of technology taking place right here in Ocala. The power plant, IHMC, Ocala 489. But did you know that important medical research is also being conducted here that will impact hundreds of thousands of people in the country someday? Maybe you've heard the name Renstar, but like so many others, perhaps you didn't realize Renstar Medical Research is one of the top facilities of its kind anywhere in the U.S. There are important studies being conducted by a highly qualified team of medical experts at Renstar, impacting decisions of major pharmaceutical companies and bringing new drugs to market. And you can be a part of these studies, as so many local people are right now. RinStar has conducted more than 500 studies since its inception and would like to extend an opportunity to you to be a part of these. Call 877-629-5800 or 352-629-5800 if you'd like to know more. RinStar Medical Research, locally owned and operated in beautiful downtown Ocala. RinStar, seeking tomorrow's answers to the health questions of today.
Hello, I'm Dawn Lovell, lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day. Whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands, at Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items is featured in our fabulous showroom. Stop by and say hello. It's a great way to get ideas for an event and experience for yourself how you can make your party time special.
Party Time Rentals, located on Southwest 10th Street, just off Route 200 in Ocala, and off Southwest 34th Street in Gainesville. For more information, call 352-629-8858. That's 352-629-8858. The party begins at Party Time.
You're listening to WOCA. Ocala.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robert and I will be speaking to Bob Natoli, the host of the True Vision television reality series. He's coming on to speak to us about his book, True Vision for Success.
Open for debate, where both sides of one issue will be debated.
And then Robert P. George will be with us. He's the McCormick Professor of Jurisprudence at Princeton University. He's coming on to speak to us about his book, Conscience and Its Enemies, Confronting the Dogmas of Liberal Secularism.
Christy Salerno-Kent is an actress and a singer-songwriter. She lives with multiple sclerosis. She'll be speaking about her book, Dreams.
And then Vlad Connors will be with us. He was born in Russia, and he is a self-professed comic book nerd. He's coming on to speak about his book, Head Smash.
Have all of your legal questions answered by attorney John B. Fuller on Legally Yours.
And then television personalities Denise Albert and Melissa Musing-Gerstein will be with us. They've been on the Today Show and Good Morning America, Fox News, and they contribute to the Huffington Post. They're coming on to speak to us about entertainment solutions to summertime boredom. All of that plus Fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Call me crazy. Some people say insanity is doing the same thing over and over, expecting a different result. I think insanity is 1,000 single-sided, full-color business cards for $15 or packing service for 50% off. Call me crazy. Regency Printing, on the corner of Northeast 25th Avenue and 24th Street. 789-6683. That's 789-6683. Look for the yellow signs.
As you're driving down the road, you may love your car, you may hate it. But the fact remains that you've got to keep it running to get back and forth to where you need to go. WOCA The Source and Sunrise Automotive are here to help with that. For a limited time, if you mention WOCA, you will receive $10 off an oil change at Sunrise Automotive. That's right, not 10%, $10 off any oil change at Sunrise Automotive. Sunrise Automotive is an ASE-certified automotive repair center, so they know how to take care of your car. Located at 1800 Northwest 10th Street, all you have to do is call to schedule your oil change, 690-1993. Mention that you heard this ad on WOCA and get $10 off an oil change. It's just that easy. So now you have 10 more reasons to head down to Sunrise Automotive, 1800 Northwest 10th Street, Ocala. And don't forget to listen to Matt every Monday morning at 10 a.m. for auto repair with personal care. Right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source, your source for $10 off an oil change.
That golden sand. Two sweethearts.
We're back on The Voice of Ocala. Breaking news. We're a little behind in our breaks and everything because of breaking news. Daniel Owen, city councilman, announced right here about 25 minutes ago that he will not be seeking re-election for a fourth term, buddy.
Well, you knew the straw would stir it up however he did it, that's for sure. So what does he do? He walks in on Tuesday and promptly announces to the world, gives it to our program first, that he's not going to run. I got a feeling we're going to see Daniel around. I'm not sure what
slow news day all of a sudden got busy.
He probably figured that one out. He probably he gauged it so it'll be a slow day. And but that's a big story, and he's a bit controversial, colorful guy, so he's done a lot, so I think that's significant. And I just think we're going to see him around other things in this, the county and the city. I'm not going to predict what, but certainly a county commissioner wouldn't be out of the picture.
He wouldn't hurt us as a county commissioner, wouldn't hurt us as a state representative, wouldn't hurt us as a U.S. representative.
I think if he decides he wants to do that kind of stuff, he has that kind of potential that he could do it. I mean, he stirs people up and gets them
passionate. Could you imagine him walking the halls of the U.S. Congress?
Well, you know what?
He'd stir that up.
We got a lot worse, I've got to say that. So I think he could do it.
He'd stir that up there.
Let's just get him back in office somewhere. I think J.J. wants to go to a quick break right again and come back. We got behind. We'll take a break, come back. And Thomas, you're teeing up your trivia again. We'll get that ready to go in the 4 o'clock hour, right?
So, yeah, we're going to start that in the 4 o'clock hour. When we come back, we're going to talk about some iconic cleaning products that have stood the test of time. See how many of them you recognize, buddy.
I could get them all.
Well, I'm sure you could. But we'll talk about that next on The Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life. From everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on The Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and the coffee pot is always on. Call your good neighbor's State Farm agent today, Angie Lewis, at 294-2444.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name.
This is a public notice. Local residents can now save thousands of dollars on their next car, truck, or SUV. It's not a tent sale, because no tent is big enough to hold this many cars. It's OcalaForSale.com. Say goodbye to sticker shock. OcalaForSale.com has thousands of vehicles with no stickers at all. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting less per contact surcharge or delivery fee. See website for details.
This is Don with ABC Frederick's Appliance. Here's my daughter, Lena.
And hey, everybody, it's Lena. You need to come down to ABC Frederick's Appliance on County Road 25, just over the railroad tracks in Bellevue, where you are treated right with the right products like Whirlpool, Maytag, Crosley, and Speed Queen. These are the new ones. Don't forget, we also carry used appliances that we warranty. ABC Frederick's Appliance does repairs, too. Call us at 629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance on County Road 25, just over the railroad tracks in Bellevue. It's at 629-5181.
News Talk 1370. WOCA invites you to discover your full business potential. News Talk Radio is the perfect environment for your advertising. WOCA's News Talk format pinpoints information hungry, better educated, high income adults. So use us to talk to them. Call 732-8000. 732-8000. We're Ocala News Talk Radio. News Talk 1370. WOCA.
Hey, I'm Gary.
And I'm Eric. Did you know that Red Eye Radio is on WOCA The Source every night from 2 to 6 a.m. and it's live?
That's right. No tape shows here.
We know that the news doesn't sleep.
And neither do we. So we're here with you live from 2 till 6 a.m. every weekday. Call us 866-90-RED-EYE. So join me, Gary McNamara.
And me, Eric Harley, every weeknight to discuss the latest in news and entertainment.
Right here on WOCA The Source.
She'd be standing next to me. Hey!
We're back on the Voice of Ocala, wrapping up the first hour. Before we went on break, Daniel Owen just announced about 35 minutes ago that he will not be seeking re-election for seat 5 of the city council. He said public service is not out of the question, just not going to be a councilman anymore. When asked about mayor, he said he didn't really think that was someplace he'd run. So Daniel Owen, out of office coming in December. The elections will be held in October. Daniel Owen not seeking re-election. Seat will turn over in December. Daniel Owen, city councilman, stepping down after 3 terms of service. Now, buddy, before we went to break, I wanted to tell people about iconic cleaning products that have stood the test of time. Some of these I didn't know were as old as they were.
So you want to ask an old guy about them, right?
No, well, I'm going to ask you if you've heard of them, and JJ if he's heard of them, and see the generation gap.
All right.
Arm & Hammer baking soda. Both of y'all heard of that?
Sure.
Of course.
1846.
Yes.
Been around
for
a long,
long
time.
About the oldest one, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Bon Ami.
Yeah, I remember that one quite well. Most people probably don't.
JJ? Yeah, I got nothing to. No.
Yeah, you didn't even know how to pronounce it.
It was a cleaner in 1890s when it was built.
Yeah,
Brillo
like,
pads. Do you remember those?
Of course. Everybody knows Brillo
JJ,
pads.
JJ, Brillo pads, 1913. Scott paper towels.
Yes.
Buddy?
Of course.
I got Scott paper towels at my house right now. 1907. Clorox bleach. I know both of you heard of that. 1913.
Naturally, yeah. Right.
I didn't realize.
Wait, Cloris Leachman, you said?
Clorox bleach.
Oh, okay.
She's a little, Cloris Leachman's a little
same,
older than that.
Okay.
I didn't realize that there was any other washing detergent when I was a kid.
Yeah, except Tide?
Except Tide. Yeah. I thought that was pretty much it.
Yeah.
1946 is when it came into existence.
Yeah.
Now, and I really didn't think there was any other cleaner besides Ajax. That's 1947. Both of y'all have heard of Ajax.
Well, Ajax, of course, is what Bon Ami was. Same kind of thing.
Comet, same thing.
Yeah.
And then I thought this had to be much older. Mr. Clean. Only 9 years older than me. I thought it was much older than
that. No, I knew it was.
1957.
Yeah, I knew that was not that old.
But those are iconic. These are still on the shelves today.
Yeah.
You can still go get Arm & Hammer baking soda. Bon Ami, I don't know. I didn't know that was still around, but it is.
I didn't either. I thought it was gone.
Sold in the Northeast mostly, they say now.
Hmm.
But Brillo pads, now the Mr. Clean White Eraser is trying to get rid of the Brillo pad.
Oh, I used to have a girl in our class whose hair was like Brillo. We called her Brillo.
Well, there's not a better thing to clean your grill when you're ready to open your grill up for the summer season.
As good as it gets.
Get the Brillo pad, mm-hmm. You can scrub the grill right up.
Absolutely.
So. Coming up in the next hour, buddy, we've pushed the Trivianator back to 4 o'clock. You okay with me taking some of your spot?
Absolutely.
There?
I mean, you know, we share here.
We share here at the Voice of Ocala. It was such a big news item with Daniel Owen stepping down, not seeking re-election. Not stepping down. He's just not seeking re-election.
Stock market dropped 200 points.
Right.
That's the news.
So that's the breaking news of the day. When we come back, Trivianator Tuesday with Tom, your chance to win historic Marion Theater tickets. Plus, Buddy Martin will tell you about something that happened 30 years ago today. I didn't realize it, buddy. It was a huge moment in history.
Doesn't seem like it happened.
Doesn't seem like it was that long ago. That means I'm getting old and you're getting older. That's what that means.
No question about it.
You're listening to the Voice of Ocala, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The Source.
Tall and she grew up right with them Indiana boys on an Indiana night.
Is your old car a strikeout? Strike one.
It's embarrassing to drive.
Strike two.
It costs too much to maintain.
Strike three.
You owe more than it's worth.
You're out of there.
Hey, this is Chris Spears from Prestige Auto Sales. I'm celebrating two of America's favorite pastimes, baseball and driving.
So this week you can hit a grand slam.
I'm giving you a ton of cash off a nicer, newer car you'll love to drive.
Are you riding the bench because of bad credit? Our For the People credit approval process goes to bat with the banks and lenders to help you get approved and back in the game.
Join the major leagues and start driving a car you love.
Come see us during our Drive It Out of the Park event and get a ton of cash off a new ride.
Hurry, this game isn't going into extra innings. The stadium goes black after we've helped 57 people score a new ride. My name is Chris Spears, and I'm a dealer for the people.
Visit Prestige in Ocala or Bellevue, or call 694-1234. See your Prestige!
Hi, this is Lisa Midget, owner of Kinetic Motion Fitness here in Ocala, Florida. A lot of you have experienced our great classes and personal spa
small group training. But did you know we now offer dynamic workouts on DVD? These high-quality, locally produced, effective DVD workouts can go where you go. Going on vacation? No problem. We can go with you. Friends and relatives out of town who are jealous that you get to come to KMF? No problem. We ship anywhere in the United States for free. Our great lineup of four DVDs includes Kinetic Achieve, Kinetic Couples, Kinetic Core, and Kinetic Campus. Four great workouts for the entire family on DVD. Sound interesting? Check them out on our website at kmfocala.com. While you're there, check out our class schedule and come see us. We're only 5 minutes from downtown across from the Skylark Plaza. Visit kmfocala.com and like us on Facebook. KMF will get you results at our studio or at home with one of our DVDs. Kinetic Motion Fitness. We're ready when you are. Visit kmfocala.com for more information.
If you need a sign or a banner for your yard or your business or your campaign, I'd recommend you go to Signs Unlimited at 318 South Magnolia in Ocala. Screen printing, embroidery, digital graphics. Do what I did when we needed signs for the Save the Marion Theater Group. Go see Vic Buttermore at Signs Unlimited if you want quality work with a fast turnaround from somebody who is deeply committed to his community and always ready to assist you. There's a reason Vic's slogan is, it's our business to make your business better. Sign up for Signs Unlimited. Call 732-7341 today.
Look who just walked in the room, Joel Wiesner from What's Up Ocala. Hey, Joel, I'm looking for something to do this weekend. You got any ideas?
Absolutely. Check out our event calendar online at www.whatsupocala.com, and there is plenty of events there for you. Daily news updates to event reviews and magazine articles.
Really?
We've organized it all in one place online for you to cut through all of the hassle of finding something to do this weekend. We have a daily event calendar, a bi-monthly magazine, and we also do daily news articles.
All right, Joel, that's perfect. Thanks so much.
Yeah, whatsupocala.com.
As you're driving down the road, you may love your car, you may hate it. But the fact remains that you've got to keep it running to get back and forth to where you need to go. WOCA The Source and Sunrise Automotive are here to help with that. For a limited time, if you mention WOCA, you will receive $10 off an oil change at Sunrise Automotive. That's right, not 10%, $10 off any oil change at Sunrise Automotive. Sunrise Automotive is an ASE-certified automotive repair center, so they know how to take care of your car. Located at 1800 Northwest 10th Street, all you have to do is call to schedule your oil change, 690-1993. Mention that you heard this ad on WOCA and get $10 off an oil change. It's just that easy. So now you have 10 more reasons to head down to Sunrise Automotive, 1800 Northwest 10th Street, Ocala. And don't forget to listen to Matt every Monday morning at 10 a.m. for auto repair with personal care. Right here on 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source, your source for 10 bucks off an oil change.
Hi, this is Brad. I want to take a moment to talk about a serious issue. In the next 5 years, the aviation industry is projected to have a shortage of commercial pilots. Now is the time to start training. Ocala Flying Club has started a scholarship for the youth of Marion County ages 17 to 24. The club will donate up to $4,000 towards a pilot's license. This will help get the student on their way to obtain their commercial pilot license. If this sounds like something you would be interested in, or if you know someone that would be, please contact Ocala Aviation Services, 861-7484.
Hey, I didn't know it rained last night.
Oh, it didn't. Why do you say that?
Because little Johnny's in the backyard playing in that big mud puddle.
Did you leave the hose on?
No, the neighbor borrowed it yesterday.
Wait, is that the side where the septic...
Johnny, get out of there!
Having septic problems? At Mike Scott Plumbing, we can make those septic worries disappear. We can pump your septic tank, repair your drain field, and, if needed, even install a whole new system. At Mike Scott Plumbing, we don't take crap from anyone. We take it from everyone. 237-2888. Mike Scott Plumbing. If water runs through it, we do it.
You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
Has to determine how it's going to do that. The Navy is opening river combat training to women now, and we could see the first female Army Rangers 2 years from now. Music may soothe more than just the savage beast. Researchers at New York Presbyterian Hospital say the softer types of music help premature infants. It slows their heart, increases their appetite, and that helps them gain weight. Many preemies exposed to classical music also leave the hospital sooner. Is there a home under construction in your neighborhood? The government says builders began work on more single-family houses and apartments last month, encouraged by more buyers and a scarcity of homes for sale. GPS has taken the pressure off drivers, mainly men, from having to ask for directions, but a new survey says that technology is often inaccurate. More than half the drivers say it's pointed them in the wrong direction or it's created a very confusing route. This is ABC News.
Hi, Tom Baudet. Most people have pretty ambitious bucket lists, like skiing every mountain in America, or seeing a game at every ballpark, or eating at all the famous barbecue joints. It can get expensive and messy. But Motel 6's great low rates mean you save more for what you travel for. So at least your stay will be a drop in the bucket. Get it? It's a bucket list. Good stuff. I'm Tom Baudet for Motel 6, and we'll leave the light on for you.
GEICO says, let's make life simpler.
It's a fact of modern life. Switching isn't easy. Your bank, your cable company, your girlfriend. Let's just say each switch comes with a certain degree of difficulty. But switching to GEICO, now that couldn't be easier. First of all, it only takes 15 minutes. And just like that, you could be saving hundreds on car insurance. No muss, no fuss. No irate, vengeful, significant others.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
I'm just sick of all the amateur stuff, you know? I mean, like, if I'm paying top dollar, I want a little production value, you know? Like some editing, transition, something, some music.
Don't worry. We didn't leave you.
He's gone. He's not gone. That's the whole point. He's never gone.
Our bosses say we gotta stay.
Check out the name tag. You're in my world now, Grandma.
Bow to your sensei. Bow to your sensei.
It's time for the second hour of The Voice of Ocala.
Hoo-ah!
You ever come across anything like time travel?
Come on. Stick around. It's free.
If you win, you win. If you lose, you still win.
All right, welcome to hour two of the program. Ordinarily, we start off with a little chit-chat and go right to Angie Lewis. Angie Lewis, not here today, but Daniel Owen was. We took most of the first half hour of the Tribunator to talk about that with Daniel. Appreciate the councilman coming by to announce he's not going to run for a fourth term.
Huge news.
Big news story. With that, we'll turn it over to the Tribunator, who now is going to do his delayed, postponed, suspended... He's on the air, the Tribunator. Go to it, bud.
All right, welcome to Tribunator Tuesday with Tom. Your chance to win two tickets to the historic Marion Theater. Let me get a question out there for everybody to answer. We're talking about elected officials, so we'll go with an elected official question. Who was the first president to visit all the existing states of the United States while he was in office? Listen to the question. Who was the first president to visit all the existing states of the United States during the time he was in office? If you know that answer, call WOC Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622. You get that one right, I'll ask you a second question. You get that one right, you'll be the proud winner of two tickets to the historic Marion Theater. Question again is, who was the first president to visit all the existing states of the United States while he was in office? If you know that answer, call the WOCA Climate Control Source Hotline, 622-9622, for your chance to win two tickets to the historic Marion Theater. Buddy, you got cable or satellite?
I have satellite.
You had cable, though.
I did.
I'm going to give you, we're going to go to a caller, but when we come back, I'm going to give you four things you should always ask when buying cable. But
too late now. JJ and our guy, we're DirecTV guys.
Who do we got on the phone, JJ?
Hugh.
Hugh, how are you today on this Tuesday?
Well, I'm trying to stay cool.
It's very hot out there, Hugh, but I have a feeling you got the air conditioning going, and there may be some product by the Miller Brewing Company involved.
I'm looking at my refrigerator as we speak, and I see a nice frosty tall one in there, and I think in about a half an hour it might pop her.
Okay. Well, Hugh, we're playing Tribunator Tuesday with Tom. The question is, what president was the first to visit all the existing states of the United States while he was in office?
That's a tricky question because you have to remember Alaska and Hawaii came in later, you know. I'm going to just guess Carter.
No, it was not Jimmy Carter.
Yeah, I think it's got to be a later president because I forget what years Alaska and Hawaii came in, but that was in the 50s, was it?
49 and 50.
Yeah, something like that, so we... But that don't mean that it was the president right at that time.
Well, who was the first to visit all the existing states of the United States while he was in office?
Exactly. Existing, that's the key. I'm seeing where you're going with this now. I get this now.
All right, Hugh, thanks so much for playing.
Okay, thanks a lot, guys.
I'm catching on to it.
You got that, don't you, buddy? Now you all of a sudden, Buddy's got it. All right. So if you know that answer, who was the first president to visit all the existing states of the United States while he was in office?
Just giving it away today, yes.
If you know that answer, call the Climate Control Source Hotline. So, Buddy... the first question you should ask, I said, well, the questions you should ask your cable company.
Mm-hmm.
First question, you know, they'll tell you the deal. Oh, it's $29.99 or something mm-hmm. like that. There's often taxes and other fees that haven't been added on yet.
A lot of them.
So always ask that, because there's DVR, which mm-hmm. is like $10 extra. HD technology is $9 extra. You got to lease the modem. That's $9. All of a sudden, what they advertise is $29.99 could cost you $100.
Yeah.
So always ask the actual full monthly price for service. That's the first thing to ask. Trivia Day Tuesday with Tom. Who we got, JJ?
Pete,
how are you today?
Good, Tom. Before I answer the question, I want to ask your opinion about something.
Okay, I'm here for... This isn't Dr. Buddy. This is Dr. Tom, so I'll give you my opinion.
Well, Tom, you're one of the smartest people I know. And
you don't know too many people, Pete.
Yeah, I know a lot of people, Tom. And doesn't it bug you when you do trivia and somebody says, oh, you must use Google?
It aggravates me all the time. I had someone last night at my trivia game that I hosted, Mojo's, say, you're not as smart as you think you are. You wouldn't be that smart if it wasn't for Google and you having the answers. I said, no, I'm smart because you know that I have the answers, and yet they're still paying me to be up here and not you, sir. Thank you.
Okay, let me try to answer the question now. Okay,
go ahead, Pete. Well, who was the first president to visit all the existing states of the United States while he was in office?
And I'm going to do this for the people who think we use Google. I'm not in front of my computer, but I'm just going to use common sense, because Franklin Delano Roosevelt was in office for the longest, and he loved to travel. He served 3 terms and was elected to a 4th term. So I'm just going to say Franklin Delano Roosevelt.
That is not correct, sir.
Well, but you see how it works, people. You got to use your logic. Thanks, Tom.
Thanks, Pete.
It's called using your brain, actually.
Pete came up with a very logical reason he picked Franklin Delano Roosevelt.
But, you know, the thing is, it's like Google has paralyzed us, because it's like this thing right here, cell phone. Do you know anybody's number?
I have no idea. The only phone number I know is mine.
Yeah, I don't know what yours is. JJ, you know my phone number?
Yeah, I know.
You know my number? Well, of course.
No, I know.
You know a lot of others.
You know your parents' house number.
JJ's got one of the best phone books.
I know my mom's cell phone, my dad's cell phone, and my house, just in case.
JJ, see, you've also got a list of sports stars.
Oh, I know a lot of
people that you have secret phone numbers.
Oh, yeah. We could go Dave Ping and...
Woody Page.
Call Woody Page right now.
No, Dave Ping and... Franz, I got them on.
Franz Beard, block. Yeah.
Oh, I know their numbers.
But you still have the secret phone numbers to a lot of people.
Yes.
Some your little black books.
You know what?
Spurriers.
I know.
Yeah, there you go.
I know. I call Buddy Martin more than I call anybody else. And I know the only thing I know about your number is the prefix.
Yeah, because I know the prefix. The one from Southwest Florida. Yeah,
that's the only thing I know.
And I know and people get aggravated.
The only reason I know that is because I lived in Southwest Florida, so I know the prefix.
You know where 941 is.
Yeah, yeah, I have no idea what your phone number is. None. And I call you more than anybody.
Yeah.
You know why? I just go to my speed dial, Buddy Martin. There you are.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just as big a victim of it or a culprit of it.
Yep.
You know, another thing. And it aggravates me to know him. We're playing Trivia Day Tuesday with Tom. The question out there on the floor, if you know the answer, call the Climate Control Source Hotline at 622-9622. Who was the first president to visit all the existing states of the United States?
So you keep saying that. I keep thinking, I know which way I'm going on that.
During his term as president.
Yeah.
If you know that answer, call WOCA Climate Control Source Hotline, 622-9622. When we get back, we're going to take a break. When we get back, I'm going to tell you something that aggravates me, buddy, when I'm shopping. And it's all because of computers. We'll do that next on Trivia Day to Tuesday with Tom, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com, The Source.
Since 1976, Daniel L. Hightower, lawyer, has been fighting for accident victim justice in North Central Florida and statewide. He believes everyone in America should follow the rules, including the insurance companies. He and his firm have experience fighting for victims of personal injury, wrongful death, workers' compensation, and Social Security disability, as well as serving those in need of help with bankruptcy, simple wills, and estate plans. The mission at the law offices of Daniel L. Hightower, PA, is to represent deserving clients and recover the maximum benefits they are entitled to by law in a timely manner. In personal injury and workers' compensation cases, there are no fees or costs unless a recovery is made. The law office of Daniel L. Hightower is located at 7 East Silver Springs Boulevard, Suite 300. For your free consultation, call 352-629-7777 or 1-888-LAW-1976 and visit danhightower.com for more information. Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice, and the proud sponsor of Ask the Cops.
This reprise of Ask the Cops is proudly brought to you by Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer. fighting for accident victim justice since 1976.
My question is, how many motorcycle patrolmen are working right now between the police department and the county, and how many are there?
The police department has six traffic officers who ride motorcycles. It is a specialized assignment. It's always the same six, and they're highly trained on how to handle that motorcycle and in traffic law investigation and enforcement. I'm not sure how many the sheriff has.
Yeah, we have around four. It's the same here. I mean, they're specially trained. They're assigned to a traffic unit. I have a sergeant over top of that unit. I had a lieutenant, but when I took office, I went ahead and made a change and put that lieutenant in a district, and so now the sergeant heads that unit. And we have motorcycles. They could be in cars, too. So it depends on them. Depends on the weather conditions.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala, Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA, The Source.
WOCA!
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
License and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
How good does it get?
Golf has long been considered to be sport's most prestigious game, and WOCA has your connection to everything in the golf world. Every first and third Thursday at 10 a.m., tune in for Let's Talk Golf with your host, PGA professional and teacher to the stars, Jim Beckett, and operations manager for the links of Spruce Creek South, Darren Irwin, right here on The Source.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that,
I need
too.
My seat replaced.
Yep, we do that, too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new
truck. Yep, we can even do that, too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show, too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Don't ever miss a single edition of the Mike Huckabee Show. We're going to have a whole lot of fun talking the big issues of the day. We'll talk to the newsmakers and the issues that made them a newsmaker, as well as we'll bring you some entertainment, some fun. You never know what's going to happen on the Mike Huckabee Show. Don't miss it.
Join Mike Huckabee every weekday from noon to 3, exclusively on WOCA, The Source.
We're back on the Voice of Ocala Trivia Night Tuesday with Tom's. Extended a little today. Got a little late start because we had breaking news walk in the studio, buddy. Not often you get breaking news walking in the studio.
Yes.
But at 15 after 3 today, about an hour ago, Daniel Owen, city councilman from seat for District 5, came in and announced he will not be seeking re-election for that seat on the city council in October during the general election. So,
and I wanted to announce it on this show.
Announced it here before anybody else got it. Before he even went and told his brethren at City Hall that he was doing it.
He's a good friend of the show.
Very good friend. Daniel Owen not seeking a fourth term as city councilman from District 5.
You know why? He wants to be the toast of this show.
Probably.
Could be arranged, by the way.
It could be. We could take some days off.
Oh, yeah.
It is Trivia Day to Tuesday with Tom, though. The question out on the floor: who was the first president to visit all the existing states of the United States while he was in office.
Are you getting this softball pass, everybody? I can't believe
it. People are striking out, aren't they?
People, you got to help me out.
Who was the first president to visit all the existing states of the United States while in office?
Judge, you know how embarrassing you know that answer. Be this next, the rest of this next
If you know
hours?
That answer, call the WOCA Climate Control
please,
Source Hotline at 622-9622.
Please call.
For your chance to win two tickets to the historic Marion Theater, you get that right, I'll ask you a follow-up. You get it right, you'll be the proud owner of two tickets to the historic Marion Theater, where World War Z will be coming soon.
Yeah,
a big zombie
March of,
party.
March of the Zombies here coming up Friday night.
Before we went to break, buddy, I was telling people about things to do when you're looking for your on your cable bill. Questions you should always ask. The first one is, what's the actual cost? Not what you're advertising. How much does it cost when everything's added together?
Yeah.
Second thing, what happens after that 3-month or 6-month promotional period?
Your bill that you got for $29 is suddenly $130.
Well, for example, you can get the Xfinity Triple Play with its TV, phone, and internet for $99 a month, but that requires a 2-year contract, and the $99 goes up to $120 after the first 6 months. Mm. But if you don't know that, it could get you. It's easy to forget that your offer is just temporary. So make sure you ask what the offer is and what you do after the offer. Third thing, is there a cancellation fee? This is always a big deal because people, they move or they decide that they're going out of state and so they want to cancel. You know, some places have up to a $200 cancellation bill that they hit you for. And if you leave the state and don't pay it, guess what they do? Ding your credit with that $200 delinquent payment. And the last thing you should always ask is, what is customer service like? While you may not be able to get an unbiased answer to this question, try asking friends, neighbors, coworkers, people who are using the service, what the customer service of that particular cable company or satellite company, for that matter, is. If you ask those four questions, your experience will be a lot better with cable and satellite companies than the average person.
Now, you have cable.
No, I have a Dish Network. You have DirecTV.
That's right, you have Dish. So we all three have satellites.
Right.
You happy with yours?
I'm very happy with mine.
What do you about local news, Channel 20?
That's not local news. That's Gainesville. We don't have any local news in this town.
Okay. What do you about North Central Florida news?
I either follow the voice of Ocala intently.
Yeah.
Or I go to ocala.com.
I'd like to say I'm missing it, but I'm not. The only thing I can say is that weather comes. But you can get that on your phone, too.
But I can get that on my phone. I get that on my computer and phone. And I like channel. The DVR is set to Channel 6, Local 6 in Orlando. Mm-hmm. I really like the way they do their news coverage. That Sean Chibot guy's a good guy covering it. He's a roving reporter about town. Mm-hmm. And then there's this Pingalore guy that's pretty good to listen to.
We're going to hear him this afternoon. JJ, you got direct. I got direct. I was asked by my daughter over the weekend, how do you like your DirecTV? And I said, pretty good.
Anybody who has Cox Cable, get rid of it. Stinks.
Whether you go with direct or Dish, both of them are better options than Cox Cable.
I would say
Cox isn't even Comcast or Time Warner, anything like that. It's like the worst cable company in America. And, of course, we have it. There's only a handful of cities in America that even
but
use
aren't cable
there's a few.
Companies.
There's a few. I mean,
all of Atlanta's.
And Louisiana has a lot of...
Let me ask you this, buddy. Aren't cable companies going the way of newspapers, though? Nobody likes their local one where they're at.
Maybe, but I think if they were smart, they'd get it, and they just generate more local news from the cable channel. Where you could actually do, like, I used to do a Gator football show on Cox.
Right.
No, we had 30 minutes a week during the season where we had, we had Brendan Martin's videos, we had interviews, we had people, we had cuts of coaches and stuff like that. And, you couldn't get that anyplace else on television around here. If cable was really smart, they'd figure this out. You can put together a show, and deliver local news, local sports an hour a day. And basically for very little money and give you something that DirecTV and Dish can't do.
When I was in Statesboro, and this was years ago, you'd think they knew it years ago, it'd still be doing. When I was in Statesboro years ago, the local cable company there, and I forget who it was, but anyway, they put on a local news show. But back then, CNN would offer you the last 4 minutes of every hour.
Yeah.
For local programming.
Which you could do, that's smart,
so they'd,
too.
They'd put a 4-minute news program on,
smart, yeah.
And they'd do it 4 times a day,
right.
So it would run 6 hours at a time.
Right.
and it was played at the end of every hour. So not only Statesboro, not only did we get the Savannah news and everything, but at the end of every hour, we got a four-minute news broadcast of Statesboro news. And believe me, 4 minutes was all you needed in Statesboro.
Yeah, I bet.
But you could do something like that here.
And actually, we desperately need a local TV show.
We need a local television.
I know the mayor has really been campaigning for that. And, you know, there's got to be... We used to have Fox News here. Robert Salat used to be running the local Fox 51 here. But now it all comes out of Orlando. You could still do a cut-in, or actually do an hour of local news at 11 right here in the Marion County market if you had, you know, they would spend some money and have a staff and put some gear in there. I know some people looked into it, tried to do it. But we desperately need our own, you know, we're going to, like Daniel said, we're going to be, you know, we're getting on close to 350 and over 400 when the snowbird season's here.
There's no way.
Enough people here. We need to have our own local
news. There's no way to have a town that's... A city, a metropolitan area that is starting to approach 500,000 people shouldn't have its own television station.
Yeah, and I don't understand why. I guess Orlando just dominates the market. But I like the Orlando stations, but local news in Orlando, I don't watch it.
We're at the very tip.
All you get there for the most part, aside from our buddy
Penguin,
and the crime report out of Orlando.
It.
I don't want to see it every night. I got other things to do.
And the only thing in Ocala they ever report on is when a crime happens in Ocala, big enough for them to come here.
Which we already know about it for a couple days.
Like when the whole election thing that went on with the sheriff's election last year.
Right.
We had already been talking about that 5 days when Channel 9, Channel 6, and Channel 2 showed up. So it was old news by the time it got to us on our television.
Right.
You know what else is old news? People's inability to answer this question.
Yeah, I think you stumped them.
The question?
I'm really surprised at Ocala, Florida. I know they know the answer to this.
You've just about given it away. Didn't I try to tell you they're not that smart? You always argue with me.
I think they must be tired today. It's too hot.
The WOCA Climate Control Source Hotline, 622-9622.
Smart people.
For your chance to win two tickets to the historic Marion Theater, if you know the answer to this question. Who was the first president to visit all the existing states of the United States while he was in office? Who was the first president to visit all the existing states of the United States while he was in office?
If you think about it, it's simple.
If you know that answer, call 622-9622.
Come on, Ocala, please.
Climate Control Source Hotline for your chance to win two tickets to the historic Marion Theater.
Well, I think they're smart.
They only got about four more minutes. Buddy.
I know they're smart people here. Of course, on the other hand, if they're smart, why would they be listening to this show?
Well, see, and now you make a lot of sense there, too. So really can't argue with you there at all.
You like Lil Wayne?
I do like some of Lil Wayne's music.
I'm having a hard time with Lil Wayne.
I'm surprised that you even know who Lil Wayne is.
Well, I've seen him on Trump's show. I know he big dogged at the NBA last year. Got upset because he didn't get his courtside tickets. It was OKC.
He's a character. And, he's not allowed at any Heat games. And then he said how he did some things with Chris Bosh's wife.
I mean, why is he so popular?
Well, he makes rap music, buddy. Rap music, but so what? Rap music is rock music.
Well, they're good. I understand that. There's a lot of good rap music out there.
Yeah, but Lil Wayne is—he's
what makes him so great.
He's top notch. This is what makes him great. Okay, rap music is a hip hop culture thing. It's sort of an African American thing. Lil Wayne somehow about 5 or 6 years
crossed over
and has all the preppy white girls in high school who buy his albums, and now he's a skateboarder and he's a rock star.
He's
a surfer. He's everything.
He's to this age group what Run DMC and Luke Skywalker, Two Live Crew were to my generation. Two Live Crew, literally, I went and bought the Two Live Crew album, the cassette, and put it in my mom's car just so I could see her reaction.
Well, I mean, look, this has been true historically. When my mother was a girl.
Y'all did it with Elvis and stuff.
Yeah, I mean, same thing. Sinatra,
Let's not
Elvis.
Compare Sinatra and Elvis to Lil Wayne, by the way.
But it's the same generation-wise thing. It's the same type thing.
You got to remember, JJ, my generation listened to rhythm and blues, which was African American culture then, okay, and we could only get it on stations that played that kind of music,
right.
And there wasn't anything around here that played it. We used to have to get it on WLAC.
Remember, Ocala used to have both kinds of music, JJ, country and western.
Let's talk about Lil Wayne for a second. Lil Wayne, He's got this new video. Have you heard about it?
No.
God bless
yes.
God bless America with a K.
Yeah.
A-M-E-R-I-K. So he revealed that he did this week, I guess, and released it in New Orleans. He's got this. He's got lyrics like, "My country, his of thee, sweet land of kill 'em and let 'em all die. God bless America with a K, the old goddess America with a K." Then he went into this video, and it looks like he's desecrating, stamping on the flag.
Right. I've seen the video. He is.
Okay, now
it's on the ground behind him. He's stepping all over it.
Yeah, he says he's not doing it. What is he doing, JJ, if he's not doing something?
Well, I don't think that he's like stomping on the flag on purpose.
Yeah.
But so what's the point? I mean, it's on the ground.
And he's stomping on it.
No, he's kind of like walking around, rapping, and a couple of times he backs into it.
He says I don't know in the final edit, you see the flag fall to reveal what is behind it, but you'll never see it on the ground. But the illusion is it hits the ground. And they asked him about the lyrics. He said, in most people's eyes, including my own, who were raised in that environment, the hood is the only America they know and the only America I knew growing up. I was fortunate for my God-given talents to escape the hood and see the other beautiful places in this country that it has to offer. But most people who were born in that environment didn't get that chance. So this is his deal. So I don't know. There apparently some people are upset about it.
What's the K supposed to say?
Just because you don't want to spell it with a C.
Okay.
Just be different, you know? Yes. I guess, right?
I guess that's what it is. We need to take a break, buddy. That means I win.
But can we give him a break?
Nope.
Even Joe's trying to play. Even
not
Joe
Teddy Roosevelt.
Not Teddy Roosevelt.
All right, listen, folks.
I got this.
JJ got it without even thinking about it.
JJ got it.
Here's the question again.
Now, I hear them play fun with Joe. I know people are smart in this community.
Who was the first president to visit all the existing
Hello?
States of the United States
while
he was
there?
In office?
Hello?
George.
Got to
be George.
The answer is George Washington. He visited all 13 states while he was in
JJ
office.
JJ and I both know it. Why didn't you know it?
All college? The existing states of the United
States.
While he was president, the only existing states were the first 13.
No, you know, I think we're going to just cancel the Terminator.
Just tell him.
We're going to cancel this Terminator show.
It's an easy question.
People don't like it. They can't answer the question.
It was an easy question.
Let's just hang it up. Say, forget about
easy
it.
Easy question.
Yeah, it was easy.
If you and JJ got it, it was an easy question.
Let me just say this. We did throw him off a little bit. Well, having the announcement in the first hour when the Terminator is normally on. So we have to give him a little bit of a benefit of the doubt.
Some people might not be listening.
The person around the radio is ready to hear you and Terminator.
And instead, they heard Daniel Owen saying he will not seek re-election for a fourth term.
So maybe we'll give him a little bit of a break today, okay?
All right. Well, you know, I got to keep everything. I'm good.
You did.
We're going to take a break, buddy. We come back. You got something happened 30 years ago today that I didn't realize it happened.
Yeah, and I'll tell you about my visit with Chris Collinsworth today at the
Really impressed lunch. You, didn't he?
Very much so, and especially when it comes to being a dad. And we'll tell you how things are going with the student loan debt these days in the country.
I know how it's going in my house. Well, not good.
I think it might be the same around the country.
You're listening to The Voice of Ocala. Stay tuned to 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Recently, I had a great conversation with General Manager Pat Murray on the special events at Country Club of Ocala.
We have a lot of events, special events here that are geared towards the family. Easter comes to mind. We have an Easter bunny who hops around on the driving range. We usually hide somewhere in a neighborhood of 3,000 eggs and turn them loose and let them go harvest the eggs. We have a great family celebration here on the 4th of July where it's a traditional cookout, if you will. And as the sun goes down, the driving range becomes alive with probably one of the better fireworks displays in the area. Breakfast with Santa is a big deal.
Country Club of Ocala, where the Easter Bunny, Santa, and all the children, large and small, are a big deal on every special occasion. For more information, call 352-237-6644. That's 352-237-6644. Country Club of Ocala, proud sponsor of the Bundy Gator Report, right here on The Source.
Hello, I'm Dawn Lovell.
lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day. Whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands, at Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items is featured in our fabulous showroom. Stop by and say hello. It's a great way to get ideas for an event and experience for yourself how you can make your party time special.
Party Time Rentals, located on Southwest 10th Street, just off Route 200 in Ocala, and off Southwest 34th Street in Gainesville. For more information, call 352-629-8858. That's 352-629-8858. The party begins at Party Time.
Phoenix Promotional Solutions, your company supplier of banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Where you give them approved artwork by noon, the next day by 4 p.m., you pick up your banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404. That's 368-2404. Don't forget, they do vehicle wraps also. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404.
Hey, I didn't know it rained last night.
Oh, it didn't. Why do you say that?
Because little Johnny's in the backyard playing in that big mud puddle.
Did you leave the hose on?
No, the neighbor borrowed it yesterday.
Wait, is that the side where the septic...
Johnny, get out of there!
Having septic problems? At Mike Scott Plumbing, we can make those septic worries disappear. We can pump your septic tank, repair your drain field, and, if needed, even install a whole new system. At Mike Scott Plumbing, we don't take crap from anyone. We take it from everyone. 237-2888. Mike Scott Plumbing. If water runs through it, we do it.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Cookies, 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 cookies.
When you want something special and fun for any occasion, get Cookies. That's right. The Great American Cookie Company in the Paddock Mall, Ocala, will make a delicious, fun-filled delight just for you. You might notice that I said fun and delicious more than once. That's because I can't say it enough. The next time you're at the mall, be sure and stop by or call 352-237-2557 to place your order.
Cookies, cookies,
yum.
Cookies, cookies. We go cookie eating cookies.
The Great American Cookie Company.
Call me crazy. Some people say insanity is doing the same thing over and over, expecting a different result. I think insanity is 1,000 single-sided, full-color business cards for $15, or packing service for 50% off. Call me crazy. Regency Printing, on the corner of Northeast 25th Avenue and 24th Street, 789-6683. That's 789-6683. Look for the yellow signs.
We're back on the Voice of Ocala with this breaking news item. Now it's an hour and a half old. Daniel Owen, sitting city councilman, District 5, came into our studios about 10 after 3 today when the show was just starting and announced he will not be seeking re-election for his city council seat. That's right, Daniel Owen came into the WOCA studios to the Voice of Ocala before he told anyone in city council or the Ocala Star Banner. Friend of the show, Daniel Owen, announced today he will not be seeking re-election. Left a window for public service open, but will not seek re-election to the city council of Ocala.
If asked, he might consider running something for something. So we'll see. I think politics is in his future. So I think he'll...
You know what's in our future? I'm just looking at the internet during the Around the Water Cooler segment.
Mm-hmm.
Phil Still has come out with his teams that fit the national championship mold. You may be surprised about some of the teams in that mold.
We all say Phil Still, but it's Phil Steele, actually.
Phil Steele.
Yeah. Yeah, well, okay, today Tom James will not be here, so we'll beat up on his Bruins for last night. They won. I think he probably celebrated.
UCLA is playing a sport right now?
Yeah, that's what I said to him when he said, I'm a Bruins fan. I said, you playing?
They're in the College UCLA? World Series? Yeah. I didn't know they made it.
And he texted me. I'm sitting there last night. I don't know where to take my phone, but I had to get up early this morning for a meeting, a breakfast meeting. So I have my phone by my my bed. I went to bed about, I don't know, about 10:45, laying there and had the TV on, sort of listening to the game, and the game was over, and I heard my phone go ding. I thought, well, I got to pick it up because, if you don't pick it up, it keeps dinging. And there's a text from Tom James, saying, two more to go. What I want to know about Tom James is how he wound up being a fan of the Boston Bruins and the USC Trojans.
Because he's a front runner.
In Ocala, Florida.
Because he's a front runer. They were the popular teams. They were the winning teams.
They weren't that popular in Ocala.
In the 70s, but they were the ones that were always on the front page of the newspaper.
This front page of
the Bruins were good at
not on the Ocala hockey. Star Banner front page.
He was able to get something.
Yeah. I don't know. The boy's not right. That's all I've got to say.
Front runner.
Anyway. Visit today. Went out to John Brantley. I had a little fundraiser today at Carrabba's. And a distinguished group of people out there, I'll tell you, that came out. Small group, maybe 50, 60 people. He's raising money for the trip they're making to play Calvert Hall in Towson, Maryland. The Celtics are traveling on their first game of the year. And he did a little fundraiser. And Chris Collinsworth, a former Gator and Cincinnati Bengal and now at NBC. I didn't know he won 14 Emmys. You realize that? So together, between the two of us, we won 15. So that's how it goes.
You have one.
Well, between the two of us, we've won 14. So it's not that bad.
There you go. So he was there today, and he has... I love his spot he does about fatherhood. He and Al Michaels talk about it, and he says it's one of the few things he hopes he got right. And I asked him about his kids today, and he asked me to send him a copy of Brendan's video on fatherhood on YouTube. And he's got two kids in Notre Dame right now, one playing football. Katie, his daughter, went to the University of Florida, now works at the Golf Channel, and he has one daughter running track at Harvard. He was very delightful, funny, told some funny stories on John Brantley, just trash Brantley, which we all love, of course, that happens. And he was there, and they had a nice little fundraiser. So I talked to Chris. We'll have him on this August before football. We got a little information on pro football. He does it. He works with what I consider to be the best play-by-play man, even now, today, on any sports in on TV, Al Michaels. I just think he's the best. He's a real pro, and he's a good technician, and Chris is a pretty smart dude himself. He's an intelligent guy, got a law degree, and he brings a smart approach to it. So anyway, good to see Chris Collinsworth today out there. 30 years ago today, where's that song, Ride Sally Ride? You got that?
Ride Sally.
It's a great song. Not to be confused with Mustang Sally. But 30 years ago today, NASA physicists broke through the ultimate glass ceiling and kept on going. June 18th, 1983. She became the first American woman to fly into space as a crew member aboard the Space Shuttle Challenger. You know, by now I'm talking about Sally Ride. Could it be 30 years ago, Sally? Women have cleared numerous other barriers since then. But think about it. 30 years ago, Sally Ride broke the glass ceiling in a big way by going through up to space, becoming the first woman to ride in space. So,
is this song about her?
No.
No, that's not the right song either.
Not the right
Al
song.
Al Green, Ride Sally Ride.
Yeah. Yeah, but not the right one.
Not the right one. But I understand.
Yeah. I couldn't believe it was 30 years. I just thought, it was like, I'm thinking that happened like, maybe 15 years ago.
Well, I remember I was when I read that you were doing this, I was like, really? And I thought about it, and yes, I was a junior in high school because we all stopped and watched the shuttle take off and everything. So,
JJ. About Dennis Coffey? Is that his name?
Maybe.
No. No. Who else recorded JJ?
There's a lot on here.
There's a lot.
Right, well, anyway, we get the idea.
Muddy Waters. Yeah. That's Mustang Sally.
No.
Yeah, Mustang Sally is also one of the great songs. Like I said,
30
it's
years
hard to
ago
believe
today.
This is actually, and we're talking about how far women have actually come. You think of this have been the dark ages for the last 50 years, but the women have done some significant things, Sally Ride being one of those things, and today is the 30th anniversary, so I thought it was worth bringing that up. Talk about it. JJ, I said, JJ, one day women will play in the football, and play professional football in the NFL, and he said, no way.
No, I think we're too politically correct to let females get whacked around like
that. Yeah, you got women boxers, JJ.
But that's different. They fight other women.
So?
They don't fight men.
Well, let me have all women's...
Well, that's the point.
Let me tell you, in the
60s... They could have an NFL for women.
In the 60s and 70s, trust me, I remember vividly people saying, there'll never be a woman astronaut. And it was a big deal.
Yeah.
Because it's a daredevil thing. Your life's in danger. It'll never happen.
Right.
1983.
Women
Sally
couldn't
Ride.
Even serve in combat.
Lou Reed, buddy?
Could be.
Let's hear this one.
Could be Lou Reed. Great song.
So, YouTube's making me wait.
Yeah. We're past the song.
Yeah. Anyway, great song. Just worth mentioning there. Also, just local news, Steve Purvis is leaving Monroe. Which is not a big surprise.
He's going to take over to Maricopa County Public Health Care.
Arizona, yeah. That's right outside Phoenix. And so he'll be leaving to go. Of course, we realize that they're kind of dismantling Monroe. So Purvis applied for the job after the negotiation began, and he's accepted that, and he's going to be leaving Monroe to go to Arizona.
So he's going to go from hot to... really, really hot.
I was talking to a guy today down at, whose son plays, by the way, high school football for Westport.
Right.
And he was telling me about visiting Arizona. He said, they told me he'd never been before. He said, I got off the plane. He said, they told me it was dry heat. He said, it was 108. It's hot. It's,
yeah.
I played golf in Arizona with 100. Believe me, it's hot. I don't care.
But, you know, I've been to Phoenix and and Tucson area in July and August, and like you, I played golf, and after 9 holes, we packed it in, because guess what?
Yeah.
It was, I don't care. Oh, it's a dry heat. 115 degrees,
right.
115 degrees, whether it's wet or
exactly.
dry. I don't
it's,
care.
It's hot.
It's hot.
You just don't sweat. All right, couple
go to
things.
Vegas, then.
Other couple of quick things before we get to the top. We got tweets and quotes, and then we got around the water cooler. Polk County arrested 41 people for sex crimes who wanted to have sex with children, a sting operation. Among the ones they arrested, an electrician, a student, an insurance salesman, a bank teller, a handyman, a file clerk, a painter, a mechanic, theme park employee, law enforcement academy graduate, IT phone technician, laborer, youth football coach, photo lab technician, heavy, and on, which tells you they're in all walks of life. That's the scary thing about it. What's that? The predators are everywhere. So... it's the good news and bad news. Bad news are out to the good news. They got 41 of them today in Polk County. A couple other facts, Tom. The world's tallest roller coaster. You know where it is?
Somewhere in Asia.
No. You're a roller coaster guy now. Come on.
Well, I don't think it's in the U.S.
The Trinidad shouldn't be, you know, should not have been stopped by
this. I don't believe it's in the U.S.
Well, it's the tallest in the world. It's 456-foot. King Kai, New Jersey, Six Flags Great Adventure.
Wow, Great Adventure in New Jersey.
Getting ready to move to Las Vegas.
Where are they going to put it in Vegas?
I haven't any idea. Well, they're moving the world's tallest. And other thing is, by the way, you know, you got a dog. You take your dog, you take your erg out. You take them in your car sometimes.
I do.
Do you wonder why they stick their heads out there? In the window? They love it. Randy likes to put
his... I thought it was cause so they could stay cool.
But that's not it, according to... They actually like the smells. Because, you know, dogs, that's how their senses are,
right.
Smells. So they love all the variety of smells. I always thought they liked the wind blowing,
that's
you know?
That's what I thought. The wind blowing in their face to keep them cool.
Yeah, that's what I thought, too. So see what you learned listening to this show? You may not know who the first president was to visit all the states, but you know now the dog sticks their head out their window because of the smells. Finally... student loan, JJ, something you don't know anything about. Hopefully you won't have to be hit by it too hard. But the student loan debt has nearly doubled in the last 5 years. Double. Man. You know, and you have to question the value of some educations you're getting, because if your goal is to get education, which you should do, that's okay. If your goal is to go get a good job, not working so hot.
Look,
especially lawyers.
My student loans equal... in excess of $80,000.
Good grief.
Because of graduate school. And the thing was, they came in at a little over $45,000, but because I've had to furlough them and everything, because you just can't make the money that they want you to repay back, mm-hmm. with furlough and then principal being added to the end and everything. It's a racket.
Bottom line is that your generation and it's going to be in debtor's prison.
We are.
It's how it's going to be.
It's ridiculous the way the government and
allowed the banks to do it.
Yeah.
You got to remember one thing. There was a time in this country, there was a law that said you could never charge more than 10% on any loan, ever. Amazing what you get charged now. It's a 20, 21, 24% on credit card debt.
Like,
it's amazing.
You go to some of these.
Well, I know, the loan sharks.
Yeah, some of these. No, but I mean, if you're like trying to finance a car or something, go to some of these car lots.
Yeah.
And not Chris Beers, by the way. Chris Beers does a good job.
Right.
But you go to some of the, and I won't say, but there's national buy here, pay here lots
right.
that are in town here.
Right.
Percentage rate's 36-37%.
Yeah.
You get a car for $10,000, you end up spending $35,000 on it.
Yeah.
And it's perfectly legal.
All right, time to round out this kind of crazy 2 hours, started with Daniel Owen announcing he's not going to run for office again. We'll end it up with tweets and quotes, then we'll do a round the water cooler without Tom James coming up in the next hour. So stay tuned. Coming up next, tweets and quotes right here on the Voice of Ocala.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Hi, it's Lisa Midget with Kinetic Motion Fitness. I'm looking forward to a fun, healthy summer, and I have a few ideas that might just help you and your friends stay in shape and have fun too. Along with awesome personal training and group classes at our warm and inviting fitness studio, we also offer fitness classes at your home or business. And if you're tired of the same old, boring cake and punch party, why not let us host a hot new health trend, a fitness party at your home or office? If you're having a hard time getting to the gym this summer, because of your crazy schedule, then work out with your friends or coworkers in a private group fitness class or host a fitness party at your home or office. We will bring you and your friends or coworkers one of our great workouts like Zumba, Piloxing, Body Bar, Yoga, Tai Chi, Boot Camp, or Zumba Tonics for kids. We can even help you reach your long-term goals by meeting at your place weekly for an on-location workout. Check out our website at kmfocala.com and like us on Facebook. Kinetic Motion Fitness is located just 5 minutes from downtown Ocala near the Skylark Plaza. Kinetic Motion Fitness, we're ready when you are.
Is your old car a strikeout? Strike one.
It's embarrassing to drive.
Strike two.
It costs too much to maintain.
Strike three.
You owe more than it's worth.
You're out of there.
Hey, this is Chris Spears from Prestige Auto Sales. I'm celebrating two of America's favorite pastimes, baseball and driving.
So this week you can hit a grand slam.
I'm giving you a ton of cash off a nicer, newer car you'll love to drive.
Are you riding the bench because of bad credit? Our For the People credit approval process goes to bat with the banks and lenders to help you get approved and back in the game.
Join the major leagues and start driving a car you love.
Come see us during our Drive It Out of the Park event and get a ton of cash off a new ride.
Hurry, this game isn't going into extra innings. The stadium goes black after we've helped 57 people score a new ride. My name is Chris Spears, and I'm a dealer for the people.
Visit Prestige in Ocala or Bellevue, or call 694-1234. See your Prestige!
Gene Powell Pasture Mowing. Our tractor services include bush hog, disking, front end loader, box blade, and stump grinding. We also have zero turn mowers for the smaller paddocks, aisleways, fence rows, and lawn care. Fence row spraying is also available for weed control. We are licensed and insured. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing, 352-629-2440, or online at PowellGene, G-E-N-E, at yahoo.com. Gene Powell Pasture Mowing.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robin and I will be speaking to Bob Natoli, the host of the True Vision television reality series. He's coming on to speak to us about his book, True Vision for Success.
Open for debate, where both sides of one issue will be debated.
And then Robert P. George will be with us. He's the McCormick Professor of Jurisprudence at Princeton University. He's coming on to speak to us about his book, Conscience and Its Enemies, Confronting the Dogmas of Liberal Secularism.
Christy Salerno-Kent is an actress and a singer-songwriter. She lives with multiple sclerosis. She'll be speaking about her book, Dreams.
And then Vlad Connors will be with us. He was born in Russia, and he is a self-professed comic book nerd. He's coming on to speak about his book, Head Smash.
Have all of your legal questions answered by attorney John B. Fuller on Legally Yours.
And then television personalities Denise Albert and Melissa Musing-Gerstein will be with us. They've been on the Today Show and Good Morning America Fox News, and they contribute to the Huffington Post. They're coming on to speak to us about entertainment solutions to summertime boredom. All of that plus Fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
In Clark, we trust.
Hi, this is Clark Howard. Join me every weeknight at 6, right here on WOCA 1370, The Source.
WOCA. WOCA.
This is WOCA, News Talk 1370.
Don't you know this is a party? Sit yourself down.
It's not the right one either.
We'll try. By the way, remember we talked about Jimmy Hoffa yesterday, digging in around Detroit to find out what happened? So they went to search for the missing body. Turned up, nothing so far. But they did unearth two concrete slabs, about 6 by 12, which is where the guy told them they would be, that Tony Zarelli. He's the son of the famous mobster. Said they were buried there, and Zarelli claims Hoffa was struck with a shovel and buried alive on the property with a slab of concrete placed over his body. However, the core samples they've taken have not revealed any DNA there at that point in time. So, once again, Jimmy Hoffa, no results. But would it be funny if he was alive someplace? You know, after all that.
He ran off with the money.
Yeah. All right, time for tweets and quotes, JJ. Let's fire up the music, wrap up the segment here on a pretty toasty, hot Trinator Tuesday. That's what we got to go today. Number one, pretty good Russian proverb. A mere friend will agree with you, but a real friend will argue. I must have a lot of friends on this show, is all I can say. Mark Twain says, to get the full value of joy, you must have someone to divide it with. Sounds like something Dr. Buddy would say. And finally, from Bat Masterson. I'm sorry, Bert Masterson. I don't know who that is. Somebody recently figured out we have 35 million laws to enforce the Ten Commandments.
I like that.
Sir, 35 million laws. Who knows how much? The tax code itself is bigger than what? But the state of Rhode Island or something is amazing, the laws. You know, and they put this stuff in all lawyerese, so you have to hire lawyers to be able to read it. What do lawyers do? They read. That's what they do. Now, look, when you need a good lawyer, and we've all needed them, it's great to have one. The fact remains, as you get right down to it, it's written is so complicated to understand. You need a lawyer to try to make sense because it has to be translated. Amazing. Coming up in the sports hour, we'll visit the topics of Game 6. We'll make our picks, tell you who will win and why, we think. And what is Justin Rose's wife do? Interesting. We'll find out what she is. She's now emerged, as Dan Jenkins said, when he saw this attractive blonde. He wanted to know if it said, Lindsey Vonn switch teams? and of course, it would be his wife, Justin Rose's wife. Heard an interview on Justin Rose today. I like the guy a lot. Tell you about a Gator who was selected for national honors to play on a national team. And what does Doris Stearns think about these interviews with Popovich? You guys seen those.
Doris Burke.
Doris Burke, I'm sorry. Think about that. What does she think about those? I don't know if you like her or not. They're all very, they're very much.
She comes off very pompous.
She does?
No, he does.
Well, that's who he is.
I know. But I don't think it's her fault or his fault. I think it's the fact that we have to watch an interview every single quarter from a coach in the middle of a game. They don't want to talk to you.
Well, that's not Doris Burke's fault.
That's what I'm saying. It's neither one of theirs.
TV's fault.
Yeah, it's ESPN and NBA.
Some people are uneasy with that.
I don't like it at all. Because the coach does not want to have to deal with that right there.
It's game time. It's not, I need to talk to you on a microphone time.
Exactly.
Well, Popovich has got it down. One word answer.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what it is.
You're only allowed to ask
because
two questions.
Because he doesn't want to be bothered with it.
Yeah. It's kind of tough. Coming up next, around the water cooler on a Tuesday right here on Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The Source. Out there without care. Yeah, I was out of touch. But it wasn't because I didn't know enough. I just knew too much. Does that make me crazy?
this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name.
The AP is reporting that two explosions at the finish line of the Boston Marathon.
There's three people confirmed dead at Boston Marathon.
Multiple people injured.
Explosion, the Boston Marathon.
Report of another possible device at the Mandarin.
Our six reported injured, no death. Workers felt the blast all the way over from Newburyport Street.
The Voice of Ocala, your eyes and ears when it really counts.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. I want to tell you about a conversation I had recently with General Manager Pat Murray on the great family atmosphere at Country Club of Ocala.
It's a family first club. Again, we have any number of different types of memberships, but obviously the one that attracts the greatest level of interest is our family. And the reason for that is we have a little bit of something for everybody. I mean, we obviously have a world-class golf course. We have seven tennis courts here for all levels of tennis players. We have a junior Olympic size swimming pool. We have a fitness center that's second to none. And we have state-of-the-art equipment in our fitness center.
Country Club of Ocala, where the facilities are all a family would ever need. For more information, call today at 352-237-6644. That's 352-237-6644. Country Club of Ocala, proud sponsor of Monday's Gator Report and Gator Talk Thursday right here on The Source.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Life jackets save lives. Where in Florida? Today will be warm but humid with a mix of clouds and sunshine, a shower with thunderstorm around this afternoon and this evening, the high 89 to 93, and partly cloudy overnight, low 71 to 75. Tomorrow, partly sunny, watch out for an afternoon or evening thunderstorm, the high 89 to 93. Thursday, partly sunny, there can be an afternoon thunderstorm, high 88 to 92. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Hi, this is Joe, and I'm your host for the new show, Damage Control, every Tuesday morning at 10:30 a.m., brought to you by Damage Control Services. We're going to be discussing floods, fires, storm and tree damage, sinkholes, mold, and many other disasters that you need to know about, how to prevent and prepare for them, as well as what to do when it happens and what to expect after it happens. This is Damage Control, Tuesdays at 10:30, right here on The Source.
Hi, I'm Tom Ingram, CEO of Gateway Bank, inviting you to drop by our main office on Silver Springs Boulevard every Friday from 3 to 6 p.m. for the Community Gazette, a three-hour show focusing on our favorite community to live and work, Ocala Marion County. Come join us with the voice of Ocala, Buddy Martin, in the new old-fashioned bank radio studio as we discuss a variety of interesting topics on the Community Gazette on WOCA The Source.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
License and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge. Undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Phoenix Promotional Solutions, your company supplier of banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Where you give them approved artwork by noon, the next day by 4 p.m., you pick up your banners, digital decals, yard signs, and magnetic signs. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404. That's 368-2404. Don't forget, they do vehicle wraps also. Phoenix Promotional Solutions, 368-2404.
1370 WOCA.
You're listening to WOCA News Talk 1370, Ocala's source for what's happening in today's hottest, up-to-date news and topics.
2016, and we could see the first women Navy SEALs go into training soon after that. Remember those contaminated steroid injections which led to an outbreak of meningitis last fall? Well, the Journal of the American Medical Association found the shots could be causing other problems, just as serious, but with a slower onset. The authors say take a proactive approach. If you got the shot, you probably should have an MRI. There may be a problem with the airbag sensors in the seats of some small Suzuki SUVs. Safety regulators say the sensors the front passenger seats turn off the airbag when a child is sitting there. The investigation covers Suzuki Gran Vitaras and XS4s from 2007 to 2011. Gas costs more, but food costs less, and consumer prices were up slightly. This is ABC News.
Never play poker with a guy named Lucky. Never hit a pinata that has hornets coming out of it. Never wear a fanny pack. No, really, don't ever wear a fanny pack. And never trust a car that hasn't been trusted to Midas. Save on brakes, tires, maintenance, and total car care for a car you can depend on long after the warranty expires. You deserve the Midas touch. Get a comprehensive oil change, free visual brake check, and tire rotation for $19.99. Up to 5 quarts conventional oil, up to 10% shop fee were permitted based on pre-invoiced retail price, not to exceed $35. Most vehicles at participating Midas.
More with less. More with
less. Sound familiar?
More.
This is what many IT managers hear every day. The IBM System X3650 M4 Express server with Intel Xeon says do more for less. It's easy to manage, designed to deliver 84% greater performance, and can handle as many workloads as 25 prior generation IBM systems, all at an affordable price. Like how that sounds? Learn more at ibm.com/moreforless.
How much time? 30? 30 seconds? I'm on right now. I don't believe you.
Okay, okay. Enough kidding around.
Ho, 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 ho! Ho, ho, ho!
And now it's time for the
Buddy Martin Sports Page.
He actually had me stay here last night in his gym.
Like I don't fit in. Like I don't belong here.
Let's go talk to a couple of guys that never gamble.
Oh, see, I made Lewis a bet here. See, Lewis bet me that we couldn't both get rich and put you on the poor house at the same time. He didn't think we could do it.
Gambling is illegal at Bushwood, sir, and I never slight.
And now,
here's Buddy.
All right, time for the program called Buddy Sports Page on a Tuesday. This is where we go around the water cooler with our cast here today. Sean will sit in for Tom James. Tom James unavailable today. We'll be talking with Dave Pingelora from Local 6. A lot of different categories to go on. But first, JJ, let's go to the news and see what's in the news today in a matter of sports.
All right. Well, there was some playoffs last night, not the playoffs we've been watching. NHL. Stanley Cup Finals, the Boston Bruins took a 2-1 game lead. This game did not go to overtime, unlike the first two. Boston shut them out 2-0. Buddy's favorite player is Zdeno Chara.
Guy's a monster.
6'9", 255. Helped steal the shutout. NBA game tonight, 9 o'clock, game 6. Miami must win. It's in Miami. The last two games are in Miami. Even though they're down 2-3, Buddy, they are favored by Vegas to still win the NBA Finals.
How about that?
And also in the NBA, we've been talking a couple days about the Los Angeles Clippers maybe acquiring Kevin Garnett and Doc Rivers.
Yes.
Apparently that's not going to happen. Our boy Dave Ping texted that, tweeted that, actually, today. But ESPN has it up now. Sources say that the Clippers are pulling out of the deal. So they may come back with something different. We'll see. Three teams got put into the World Cup today, Buddy. Iran, one of them. Iran, South Korea, and Australia. And the United States plays tonight in soccer, so they can further their chance to go to the World Cup. They play Honduras, 9 o'clock.
First of all, I've never seen a guy that big on hockey, I don't think. Is this guy's that guy Chara, whatever his name is? He's the captain, and he's also the enforcer. You don't see many enforcers as the captain.
You just don't. You know?
No.
You have the brains and the brawn. You know, they usually do. And that guy is, I mean,
well,
he's.
Well, unless you're me, and then you have both.
Okay, like I said, you don't see many people with brains and brawn. This guy swats people out of the way. He just, like, picks up people and throw them. And just, he's a monster. I watched some of that game. I know that I got a text last night when I was already in bed from you-know-who, who's not here today, saying, two to go, Tom James, who somehow is a Boston Bruins and USC Trojan fan.
And a San Francisco 49ers fan.
I don't get it. I don't get it.
A New York Yankees fan.
You know,
fan,
the boy's not right. The boy's
just not right. A Cardinal fan. No. Exactly. All that CLs, I'm a front runner.
Chara is the tallest player in the NHL.
Yeah. And now, by the way, well, how big is he?
6'9", 255. Number two is Joe Finley for the New York Islanders, 6'8", 260.
Hey, so, did you see Chara's skating warm-ups last night?
And he knocked over his own guy?
He knocked him over. He clipped him in the back.
So they're both 20 pounds smaller than me.
I'm not
impressed.
I thought that guy was going to get hurt, JJ. Yes. He took him out. He leveled him, his old teammate, from the behind.
They did win the game.
Won the game, exactly. Go back to a second to that story about Doc Rivers. We'll have a little talk about this later on. Very unusual. There have been situations where coaches have been traded to teams. I think if we Google it, we'll find two or three. I think Shula might have been one. I had to give a draft choice up. But, I mean, Doc Rivers going, you know, he's got $35 million he's going to be owed in Boston if he stays to the duration of his contract. Clearly doesn't want to be there. He's taking Kevin Garnett and his basketball and going to California. I'm saying, how's he ever going to stay in Boston?
I heard that the Clippers weren't getting enough. And that's why they pulled out of this. They think they're giving up way too much in DeAndre Jordan and Bledsoe and getting an old player that maybe has a year or two left in Kevin Garnett and a coach, Doc Rivers, that they're going to pay a lot for. The Clippers think right now they're straight as it is with who they have. Bring in somebody like Byron Scott, Brian Shaw, who I guarantee they'll hire one of those guys. They think they're just as good off with those players and one of those coaches than having to give up that and Doc Rivers.
It's all who Chris Paul wants.
And the NBA, exactly, is a players' league.
Well, here's the thing. Here's my problem. If the Clippers thought they were so good, why'd they get bounced so early in the playoffs?
Because they're not that good.
They're not that good.
Well, but Griffin was hurt, too, really. He wasn't 100%, and they had some other injuries.
Griffin was hurt.
But Blake Griffin...
he's the most overrated player in the NBA by far.
Thank you. Can we go ahead and just say, just because he's a big body and he can slam dunk and make highlights...
That's all he is.
He can't put the ball on the floor. He has no jump shot. He can slam dunk the ball and he can rebound some.
I'd argue...
That doesn't make a great player.
I would argue that he has good hands, soft hands. He has a good shot. He runs really well for a big man. He's pretty strong.
He doesn't have a good shot, though.
Well, he's not
he
bad.
Doesn't have a great shot.
That's not bad.
He does have soft hands around the rim, though.
When you go to the hoop and you slam it, you got a good shot.
If you get him farther away from the basket than 6 or 8 feet, he's in bad shape.
Well, he's got great moves with his back to the basket.
He doesn't have that little 12-foot jumper.
The way that we see him through ESPN's eyes, you would think he's the greatest player in the NBA right now.
Because he's a highlight monster.
Exactly. But I don't think he's the type of player that's going to bring the Clippers a ring.
No. Well, we'll see. Anyway, I agree with you on one thing, JJ. I don't think it is a great deal for them. I think it's a bad deal for the Clippers. And I think Doc's a good fit for them. I
think he's one of the best coaches in the NBA.
Yeah, but again, he comes with a high price tag. I think that's part of the deal. Garnett's got some good years left in him. Imagine that front line with Garnett and Griffin on that. It's a whole different animal. If you have Garnett in there, clean up your mistakes.
How old is Kevin Garnett? 34?
Probably.
Kevin Garnett had some decent games mixed between some bad performances. I don't know if he does have a year of great basketball.
Is he 34, 35?
You know what? Talk to players and who play with him and coaches that coach with him. He is like some max effort guy. He's a physical freak. He's in top-notch condition. He never gets hurt.
76.
37.
Is he 37?
Yeah, he's 37. Well,
he'll play two more years.
Yeah, buddy, but he's been playing in the league since he was 17.
So he didn't have to carry a team.
That's the thing. He's got 20 years on him already.
But I don't think he's a big thing in this deal. I think it's basically the 3 years, $21 million on Doc Rivers' contract.
I agree.
That's a lot of money to pay a coach.
I agree. All right, take a break. Come back. We're going to have Dave Pingalore. We'll talk about some other things, including Justin Rose. I heard a couple interviews with him. And what does his wife do? I'm learning more. We're learning more about who she is and what she does. We'll talk about a basketball player who's doing pretty well for himself. And you guys got a couple of stories. What do you guys talk about today?
I actually was going to talk about the Mets losing a no-hitter, but that's so not a good story when I ran across this story. Phil Steele, he's got a team, his motto out there. He says, which teams fit in the national championship mold in 2013? He has 14 teams, some of you may be surprised of. And then Monta Ellis, who is opting out of his final remaining year of Milwaukee Bucks. There's talk now. It's in the rumor stages, but J.J. can tell me whether it makes sense or not. A talk of him and somebody else joining up in that person's hometown to play a little basketball. So, I got that.
My two stories. One involves the NFL and a certain very famous soccer player. And the other one is to settle a debate between J.J. and Tom earlier today about who's better, Kobe Bryant or Tim Duncan?
You want to settle that?
I don't know how you're going to settle that, because JJ said it's a stupid question.
I still think it's stupid.
Okay, let's see. I got a feeling you're not going to settle it, but anyway. So.
Yeah, I know. This was a horrible idea for Sean to bring that on the air.
Well, okay. Sorry. But there are no horrible ideas. I'm going to ask a really stupid question. Should all NBA players be required to wear the same kind of shoes? Think about it just for a minute, okay? Think about it.
I'm not going to be on the same side as
you. Wait. How do you know what side I'm going to be on? You don't know that
just
yet.
Just for bringing it up.
I'm asking a question. That's just what this is. It's called Around the Water Cooler, where we all sit and share ideas, and we don't call them stupid or say how bad they are when somebody brings it up. That's kind of how it works.
What's JJ got going on?
Well, let's find out. What you got going on, JJ?
We got some Lolo Jones news, buddy. We got some Atlanta Falcons news.
Yeah.
The Lolo Jones news is funny. We even got Allen Iverson news.
I'm sorry. Who's Lolo Jones?
You don't know who Lolo Jones is?
No, I'm just making a point. You say when the Olympics aren't around, nobody knows who these people are.
I got a question for you. Who's Keith Sweat? Anyway.
You know what? When he said that yesterday on the show, I was praying to God it was not like an adult film star name. Because it definitely sounded like
that. Do you think I brought up as an adult film star?
You didn't know who he was.
Thought crossed my mind. However, but I could tell from his quote, that he wasn't. The character came through. So we'll take a break. We'll come back and we'll talk more around the water cooler. Dave Pingalore could be coming up next. We're not sure. Sometime in the next 20 minutes, stay tuned to the program called Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com. The source.
Hi, this is Tom Schmitz, the host of Buddy's Saturday Sports Page on WOCA. The Saturday Sports Page is your weekend destination for everything sports, from NASCAR to golf, baseball to boxing, and of course, the best, most comprehensive football coverage on the radio. Also, you don't want to miss my weekly Are You Kidding Me rant? So join me and JJ LaSalva every Saturday morning at 10 a.m. for Buddy's Saturday Sports Page on WOCA, The Source.
Since 1976, Daniel L. Hightower, lawyer, has been fighting for accident victim justice in North Central Florida and statewide. He believes everyone in America should follow the rules, including the insurance companies. He and his firm have experience fighting for victims of personal injury, wrongful death, workers' compensation, and Social Security disability, as well as serving those in need of help with bankruptcy, simple wills, and estate plans. The mission at the law offices of Daniel L. Hightower, PA, is to represent deserving clients and recover the maximum benefits they are entitled to by law in a timely manner. In personal injury and workers' compensation cases, there are no fees or costs unless a recovery is made. The law office of Daniel L. Hightower is located at 7 East Silver Springs Boulevard, Suite 300. For your free consultation, call 352-629-7777 or 1-888-LAW-1976 and visit danhightower.com for more information. Daniel L. Hightower, PA lawyer, fighting for accident victim justice, and the proud sponsor of Ask the Cops.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. If you have an award or a trophy in your house, there's more than a good chance it came from BJ Trophies Gifts and Awards. At BJ Trophies, Floyd Hirschberger and his staff have a lot more than just trophies. Among the items they specialize in are donor recognition walls and trees, personalized or engraved gifts, cast bronze dedication plaques, wide format digital printing with posters, banners, and signs, and promotional products. Floyd is the official trophy and awards maker for the Voice of Ocala radio show and is North Central Florida's leader in custom recognition programs, corporate awards, industrial engraving, unique gifts, and advertising specialties. When Angie Lewis went shopping for something to award to the winners of her State Farm Good Neighbor Award, she shopped first at BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Check them out at 1735 Northeast Jacksonville Road on North Magnolia's Miracle Mile, or call them today at 352-732-2249. BJ Trophies Awards and Gifts. Trophies is just our middle name.
WOCA.
On the next AM Ocala Live, Robert and I will be speaking to Bob Natoli, the host of the True Vision television reality series. He's coming on to speak to us about his book, True Vision for Success.
Open for debate, where both sides of one issue will be debated.
And then Robert P. George will be with us. He's the McCormick Professor of Jurisprudence at Princeton University. He's coming on to speak to us about his book, Conscience and Its Enemies, Confronting the Dogmas of Liberal Secularism.
Christy Salerno-Kent is an actress and a singer-songwriter. She lives with multiple sclerosis. She'll be speaking about her book, Dream.
And then Vlad Connors will be with us. He was born in Russia, and he is a self-professed comic book nerd. He's coming on to speak about his book, Head Smash.
Have all of your legal questions answered by attorney John B. Fuller on Legally Yours.
And then television personalities Denise Albert and Melissa Musing-Gerstein will be with us. They've been on the Today Show, Good Morning America, Fox News, and they contribute to the Huffington Post. They're coming on to speak to us about entertainment solutions for summertime boredom. All of that plus Fun with Joe on the next AM Ocala Live right here on The Source, WOCA 96.3 FM.
1370 AM.
Hi folks, I'm Seth McBride with Pasture Sports, here today to tell you about our annual early buy school uniform sale, calling all students and parents. Now is the time to buy your school uniforms from Pasture Sports. Buy now, save huge for next year. So come on down to Pasture Sports for the only big school uniform sale of the year. Located on Highway 200 across from Honda Ocala, Pasture Sports, your uniform experts.
Hi, I'm Russ with Climate Control Mechanical Services, and I want to invite you to tune in every Thursday at 10:30 a.m. to listen for tips and answers to the many questions you may have about your air conditioning and heating for your home or business. The Climate Control Show, every Thursday at 10:30 a.m. right here on WOCA, 1370 a.m. and 96.3 FM, The Source.
Back to the Tuesday edition of Buddy Sports Page. Going around the water cooler, we're bringing in now our expert from down in Orlando. He's already tweeting and making comments about things today, and he's busy, got his eye on Game 6 tonight, and he's all over it, our friend Dave Pingelor from Local 6. David, how are you, buddy?
Good. How are you guys?
All right, give me your prediction right now.
Oh, and the NBA, gosh, you know, how do you pick this series? You got to go with the home team, and then the games have been terrible, except for like one game. They've been so lopsided. I'm going to say tonight's lopsided in favor of the Heat, and then let's flip a coin on Game 7. Mm. And then all of a sudden it'll be like this unbelievable Game 7 that goes back and forth.
I like it. I think
that's what's going to happen.
Yeah, it's a good story. Unfortunately, the best story didn't prevail at the U.S. Open. Too bad that Phil couldn't win an Open for the first time. But so what an impression I think Justin Rose did make after that event was over. I think people really, he's kind of won the hearts of people, hasn't he?
Well, yeah. I mean, Justin lives here in Orlando and over in Lake Nona, but mm-hmm. I've interviewed Justin, been around Justin a few times. And every time I've seen him, he's been very gracious, very nice. Doing an interview, I saw him down at Doral this fall, saw him at Bay Hill. So just a super guy. Played some really good golf out there. Didn't break down. His nerves didn't break down. I watched every shot of that golf tournament. It's amazing how many guys. I mean, Steve Stricker hit a shank. Okay,
amazing.
That's pure nerves. If you play golf, hitting a shank, and you're a professional golfer or a low handicapper, mm-hmm. that's just complete nerves. And I, sure. and Stricker, if you go through the years and you watch a lot of golf, Stricker tends to get nervous. You know, it's funny. There's a reason why he's 46 and never won a major. Okay. And when you go ahead and you try to pick a winner in a major, you got to pick a champion. You got to pick a guy that's been there. You got to pick, like Luke Donald's, he doesn't win anything. He's not like the number one golfer in the world for a long time, but mm-hmm. he never really won anything. You know, so he gags. So it's fun to watch, you know, those guys play a golf course like an average golfer would play their own golf course, where, you know, a guy that's, you know, maybe a 6 to a 17 handicap is playing a easy golf course and where par is good, and when those guys, in order for those guys to look like a normal guy in a normal golf course, they're going to play a course that's impossible. So
yeah, I think people like to watch. Like to see them struggle. I think we do like that. What do you know about Kate Rose? I did not know she was apparently a world-class gymnast.
I did not know that. I don't think many people, you know, knew that about Justin. You yeah. know.
Seemed like, you know, somebody tweeted, Dan Jenkins tweeted, when he saw Kate come over, he says, I thought Lindsey Vonn switched teams there for a minute, you know? She's, of course, blonde.
Like, yeah, well, she has the blonde hair. So.
Yeah. So a big win for Justin Rose. Europeans have a, you know, big win, first time in 40 years, you know, whatever. You know, think about him, we don't know. He's really South African. That's what's funny about it. He's born in South Africa. But he moved,
right.
And people don't, and you know, if you think about his accent, you can see that, because he didn't have that hard British accent, you know.
Correct.
And he sounds more like Ernie Els than he does, you know, somebody from Great Britain. So, all right. So you're good with that. We got the NBA tonight, and what about the Predators? Are you still calling it the Predators, or what's going on there?
Yeah, we got the arena football game. Actually, Predators have won like two in a row. They're right in a playoff spot, and we got the game against Lynn Swan, owns the Pittsburgh Power. So that game will take place right here on Local 6 on Saturday night at 7 o'clock. So, you know, it's funny about, you know, arena football. A couple weeks ago, we did a game on Local 6. Some of our games are done on our secondary channel, 6.2. But when we broadcast the game on Local 6, and we did, I think our last one was the beginning of June, I want to say, like maybe June 8th. Our ratings on a Saturday night, we beat the Red Wings and Blackhawks hockey game, and we beat the Mets-Braves game on regular Fox Network. So, you know, we get a big tune-in factor. It's still football. You know, it's funny. Some of these guys, I mean, the guys that do play are just a tad bit slower and just could not get to the NFL. I mean, they've been invited to a lot of camps. But, you know, the quarterback the other night for Cleveland, his name's Chris Dieker, and he was a four-year starter and won two championships playing at Southern Illinois. And he's like 6'4". They're like, why isn't he in the NFL? Well, he tried with the Steelers and got cut. But, you know, it's interesting. Some of these, I mean, they're really top-notch, but just not good enough to be in the NFL.
Well, look at San Antonio Spurs. Look at Green. The guy who kicked around. Look, he's a star all of a sudden. So, you know, the role players, I mean, Leonard and Neal and Green have had fantastic minutes for Popovich. By the way, I see that you tweeted that that the Doc Rivers deal will not happen.
Nah, he's not going to Clippers. I you know, the funny thing is about that story is I know Doc, and he lives down here, obviously, in Winter Park, and I can rest assure you that he is not going to the Clippers.
Is that a pink scoop?
Well, I mean, I said it, so I don't know. We'll see. But yeah, that deal will die very soon, trust me.
Well,
you'll notice Doc has not come out and said a word about anything.
Well, there you go. It's another pink exclusive. You had Urban Meyer going to Ohio State. You know, now you got no deal for Doc Rivers. Another story broken by the great pinkster.
Yeah, all these, you know, it's like a media big story. And you know, Chris Broussard is like 50, a little bit more than 50. Listen, he's not leaving. He's not going.
Yeah. Well, David, what's on the newscast tonight? Sportscast Local 6. You have ping pong going
last
on?
Last time I had Dan Marino on. I got a little bit more Dan Marino coming on here at 6.
Yeah.
He was in town promoting a new restaurant in Altamont Springs, a new pizza place. So I'll have a little bit more of that interview and talk about the Magic getting ready for the draft. They'll be in New York City next week for the draft. So I can, you can call me in from New York. So I'll be in New York covering the draft, and Magic had the second overall pick. Yeah. So we're going to talk about
we'll
that a little
bit. Do that for sure. Did Jas Marino about his new jewelry shop?
I did not.
Marinos, they sell everything in jewelry but rings. Ba-doom-ba. Sorry about that.
That's a good one.
I'm sorry. Listen, we'll be watching tonight, my friend. Thanks a lot. Appreciate it.
All right. Sounds good. Thanks.
Dave Pingalore. You know, it's
too bad.
He's
rough on Dan Marino.
Too bad. Yeah, I like Marino. I mean, I played Pitt. People forget who he played for. Okay, so there you have it.
Who was the quarterback before Dan Marino that blew his knee out?
Yeah, Pitt. I don't know.
Robert Haygood.
Why would I know that?
Because Robert Haygood was supposed to, he was a Heisman Trophy hopeful, and he blew his knee out during preseason practice, and Dan Marino stepped in. The reason I know this is Robert Haygood used to run the Boys and Girls Club in Atlanta that I volunteered at.
I figured there's some Georgia connection. By the way, Tom, just so you know, I used to tell all my writers who wrote the guy was a Heisman Trophy hopeful, every football player is a Heisman Trophy hopeful. Every one of them that plays is a Heisman. But you're saying a good, strong
kid. Yeah, Haygood was a very good quarterback at Pittsburgh.
All right, who's up first in a round of water cooler? Who wants to go? JJ, can we get some water cooler sounds or
what,
something?
Do you want to take a break first before we start?
Yeah, let's take a break.
All right, well, let's get the water cooler sounds going, like the bubble, bubble, bubble,
will.
Whatever. And I'm going to ask you, I got a good one for the new segment at the end called Free for All, where we all get to talk about it. All right, coming up next right here on the Voice of Ocala Budding Sports page on
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, streaming live at WOCA.com, the source.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And so is State Farm agent Angie Lewis, working hard to serve her community as a citizen and insurance agent. Angie wants to help you as you adjust your insurance needs to your life. From everything to helping educate your teen driver to protecting your family against everyday risk. She wants to change the way you perceive insurance by developing relationships with her clients, which is why Angie and her staff are proud to be a part of so many good causes in Ocala. In turn, she has chosen to single out those who step up as leaders. Each month on the Voice of Ocala, Angie spotlights a good neighbor, saluting those who give exceptional service or do random acts of kindness to others. For this, Angie was written up in State Farm's National Magazine. Angie also supports local businesses with a regular Biz Buzz. The Angie Lewis State Farm Agency is located at 1122 Northeast 36th Avenue, where visitors are always welcome and a coffee pot is always on. Call your good neighbor's State Farm agent today, Angie Lewis, at 294-2444.
Hello, I'm Dawn Lovell, lead event designer and owner at Party Time Rentals. Have you ever wondered what it takes to make an event spectacular? Well, look no further. It's what we do every day, whether you're hosting an intimate dinner for 10 or a gala for thousands. At Party Time Rentals, we find just the right style and elegance to make your event a success. Our extensive inventory of the finest in chandeliers, tents, crystal, china, and specialty items is featured in our fabulous showroom. Stop by and say hello. It's a great way to get ideas for an event and experience for yourself how you can make your party time special.
Party Time Rentals, located on Southwest 10th Street, just off Route 200 in Ocala, and off Southwest 34th Street in Gainesville. For more information, call 352-629-8858. That's 352-629-8858. The party begins at Party Time.
Look who just walked in the room, Joel Wiesner from What's Up Ocala. Hey, Joel, I'm looking for something to do this weekend. You got any ideas?
Absolutely. Check out our event calendar online at www.whatsupocala.com, and there is plenty of events there for you. Daily news updates to event reviews and magazine articles.
Really?
We've organized it all in one place online for you to cut through all of the hassle of finding something to do this weekend. We have a daily event calendar, a bi-monthly magazine, and we also do daily news articles.
All right, Joel, that's perfect. Thanks so much.
Yeah, whatsupocala.com.
You've got a garden and we've got a show for you, called You've Got a Garden with your host, Master Gardener Carol Ann Baldwin. Carol Ann answers your questions about your flowers, your veggies, your grass, your trees, even questions about your bugs. And she's only on WOCA, so don't miss Carol Ann Baldwin and You've Got a Garden each Tuesday from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. right here on WOCA The Source.
This is Don with ABC Frederick's Appliance. Here's my daughter, Lena.
And hey, everybody, it's Lena. You need to come down to ABC Frederick's Appliance on County Road 25, just over the railroad tracks in Bellevue, where you are treated right with the right products like Whirlpool, Maytag, Crosley, and Speed Queen. These are the new ones. Don't forget, we also carry used appliances that we warranty. ABC Frederick's Appliance does repairs, too. Call us at 629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance on County Road 25, just over the railroad tracks in Bellevue. It's at 629-5181.
Hello all, Joe Martone here for karaoke time. You hear me each morning for the segment of Fun with Joe? Well, fun is what I do. So the next time you want to have a get-together, for just about any reason, give me a call. 470-0276 for karaoke time. That number is 470-0276. Everybody likes to sing, and with the words on the screen, it's just that much easier. Call karaoke time, 470-0276, for the next event, big or small. Karaoke time can keep the fun in your business, too.
Hey, I didn't know it rained last night.
Oh, it didn't. Why do you say that?
Because little Johnny's in the backyard playing in that big mud puddle.
Did you leave the hose on?
No, the neighbor borrowed it yesterday.
Wait, is that the side where the septic...
Johnny, get out of there!
Having septic problems? At Mike Scott Plumbing, we can make those septic worries disappear. We can pump your septic tank, repair your drain field, and, if needed, even install a whole new system. At Mike Scott Plumbing, we don't take crap from anyone. We take it from everyone. 237-2888. Mike Scott Plumbing. If water runs through it, we do it.
WOCA. Leaking through a roll down window. We both know when that seed lays back.
All right, welcome back to Around the Water Cooler on Tuesday with Buddy, Tom, Sean, JJ, and the gang. And thank you. There's a little. What does it sound like?
A water cooler.
Sounds like a toilet.
It's a water cooler. Water coolers sound like toilets.
They do? All right. Well, thanks for trying. Well, okay. I'll take it. All right. Who's up first? Who wants to go? Let's go.
Let's do the shoe thing. This is. Yeah. I'm ready.
That was my free for all segment.
Okay. Well, then, all right. Well, how about this? Monta Ellis, JJ announced a couple days ago, Monta Ellis is opting out of his remaining year of his Milwaukee Bucks contract. It's worth $11 million. Of course, now reports are starting to crop up of all the teams that are likely to line up for his services. Chris Broussard saying the Dallas Mavericks, the L.A. Lakers. But he's saying that Monta Ellis has said the team that sounds the most appealing to him, because it may be the only place he could get a guy that he's wanted to. They've both had a long desire to play together, Dwight Howard. They both could go back to Atlanta. Atlanta has the cap room. Dwight Howard's from Atlanta. Monta Ellis is from Mississippi. They're both Southern boys. So, yay or nay, the possibility that Monta Ellis, or does anybody care that Monta Ellis is trying to team up with
Dwight?
Well,
first of all, it would require someone known who Monta Ellis is.
See,
that's
what's sad. Yeah. He's a great player.
Well, that's
in
okay.
NBA.
But, I mean, the fact is, look at Green. He's a great player, too.
No, he's not. Green has had a great playoffs. He's not a great player in the NBA.
He's been a great player in the playoffs, okay?
That's what I'm saying. Monta Ellis is a great player.
But I guarantee you, 8 out of 10 people do not know who Monta Ellis is. He may be. He hasn't made his name yet.
8 out of 10 people didn't know who Danny Green was until a week ago.
He played for Golden State and Milwaukee.
I didn't say he wasn't a good player. I said nobody knows who he is. There's a reason.
But
he hasn't made his name
yet. But my question is, aren't you about tired of these, let's get together and go create a superpower?
No, what the heck? I wouldn't mind.
The NBA is now. You got to get three guys, you know?
Take my player to California
this
and my
is,
ball.
This is the last time, I think in a long time, we're going to see an actual team be able to win the NBA Finals. And talking about San Antonio as just not these superstar players that are, you know, three people versus five. It's everybody from the last guy on the bench, basically, for San Antonio to the starting five. It's a great team. There's not a lot of – there's really no other great teams
I
could think of.
I would argue, though, that this three-man greatness, people forget that back in the day, Michael Jordan, Scottie Pippen, and Horace Grant, somebody said, oh, Horace Grant, he was considered a top-notch player. That was three. Then Rodman came in and took his place. That was three. You had Bill Laimbeer, Isaiah Thomas, John Sally, and Dennis Rodman. There were four of them with Detroit. This is not a new phenomenon in the NBA.
Difference. So those guys in Detroit were all made the team together. They made the team.
But there was three or four of them.
But they didn't come in for free agents all at one time. It's different. You're talking about guys going.
I'm not talking about free agency. I'm talking about The people, the super teams, it's got to have, you got to have three great players to win championships.
Well, that's a different subject.
This is not a new phenomenon.
But it's not the same thing as going out now and getting
three
players.
Now they're trading, or these guys are hooking up in the off season and getting together and making plans to be on a super team with their homies.
So is it the problem then that the NBA management's not making the big teams? It's the players who get together in the offseason and doing it themselves.
Players' league. By the way, I don't care about Monte Ellis. I'm sorry.
I think that if Monte Ellis does go to Atlanta with Dwight Howard, they're going to be great, but they're not going to.
I'm tired of Dwight Howard too. By the way, where he wants to go. All right, what you got, Sean?
All right, first I'll talk about the odd story on NFL.com. Guess who was given a chance to get a kicking spot in the NFL. Give him a tryout.
The NFL tryout? Yeah. Kick as a kicker?
Yeah.
Well, by the way, you said it must be a soccer player.
Yes.
David Beckham. That makes perfect sense. He's got a foot on him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but the article said that basically if Beckham was to even come close to signing with anybody, it would be more of a publicity stunt than anything
obviously.
Else.
Yeah.
But can you teach a guy to kick a football that already is very good at kicking a ball, JJ? Do you think it's possible to teach him to kick a football accurately?
I have
accurately?
No idea.
Most kickers now have soccer background.
Right. Because David Beckham, let's be honest, in his heyday, there wasn't a better foot in the game for free kicks than David Beckham.
What did you just say? Every great kicker has been a soccer-style kicker.
Right.
No, you and I go back long enough.
We had Mark Mosley kick straight on, Tom Dempsey kick straight on.
Let me finish the sentence. There were a couple, but now there are none.
There are none. George Blanda kicked straight on.
Because they have the soccer-style kicking. I think he could do it. Would he? No.
No. He made $47 million.
Why would he? He doesn't have to. And plus, he could get crushed back there, too. So.
Go ahead. Kicker, hey, can you imagine that, JJ? He would only have to kick it. He'd only be able to kick extra points and field goals.
No, he couldn't.
Never do a kickoff. Because somebody would be some guy on the 53-man roster. Oh, I'm going to make a name for myself. Posh Spice is going to be husbandless.
All right, JJ, what you got?
We got Lolo Jones, buddy. Not everybody remembers Lolo Jones.
Lolo Jones
is the virgin
female
track runner.
Yeah, female hurdler.
That became famous because she was a virgin and she ran track for the USA and she cried and didn't get any medals. Because
she's not that good.
Yeah, so she switched over to bobsledding. Right. I don't really see the parallel between bobsledding.
Because you got to have a sprinter to push the cart.
Okay.
Willie Gault did it. Herschel Walker did bobsledding.
My bobsledding background is that Disney movie.
The John Candy movie, right.
Yeah. So I don't really know. But anyways.
It was a Jamaican bobsled.
Yeah.
Cool Runnings.
Awesome movie, by the way. Anyway,
based on a true story.
She tweeted out a Vine video today, which showed a $741 check, and basically for 7 months with the bobsled team,
that's what she made.
That's what she made for training, and she tweeted it out and said, "I'm going to be a little late on my rent this month." Obviously, a joke. She's paid big sponsorships, but the rest of the bobsledding world did not take too kindly to Mrs. Jones's comments. Apparently, Stephen Holcomb is a gold medalist and the most accomplished American bobsledder in history.
Certainly.
He said that's $741 more than most people in the sport made. So,
it's
a lot of backlash.
It's not a very well-paid sport.
Obviously not.
Okay.
But I didn't think that any Olympians got paid at all.
Stars get paid tons of money.
I didn't know that.
Oh, big money.
Huge
money.
I thought they got paid by their sponsors.
Well, first of all, look at the NBA players. I mean, they'll go to the Olympics. I mean, obviously.
Like here, did you know, JJ?
But the NBA players don't get paid.
But did you know an American track star, gets paid appearance fees to go to track meets in Europe?
Make millions of dollars.
Yeah.
Track stars are millionaires.
Yeah.
That's strange to me that in Olympics you can go from that much money to that little money.
Because of the sport. You go to a bobsled event in Sweden, there may be 4,000 people there. You go to a track event in France, 100,000 seat stadium sold out.
Plus, if you talk about guys driving, the drivers who drive the Formula Ones, they're megastars.
I know
in
that.
In Europe, they're megastars.
Formula One's my favorite auto racing sport.
I'm going to go local with one of mine, just because I want to get on record today.
Daniel Owens, not going to run for re-election.
He's not going to win the American Masters. I met this kid today. We've talked about it on the show a couple of times. I'm going to go on record as saying, unless this kid gets hurt, you're talking a guy who's going to be a superstar football player in college, maybe in pros. He'll be the Dante Culpepper type of guy that, you know, that's going to go on to the pros. This kid is something special. I actually had a chance to talk to him just briefly. Jordan Woods, freshman, because he'll be a sophomore this year. Already offered by Florida State, Miami. Today, Georgia offered him a scholarship. He's 15 years old. He's 6'4", and I think he's
235
and a 3.5 GPA.
That's unless it says defensive lineman slash tight end.
It's a defensive end.
But that's the thing. It's not that he's 6'4", 6'5". It's not that he's 235. It's not that he's 15 years old. The most impressive thing to me there, 3.5 grade point average.
And the most impressive thing to me was shaking a young man's hand, looking up to him in the eyes, and looking at him and seeing what a fine-looking young man he was. And so I just want to put that out there. Remember the name, Jordan Woods, going to be a huge star in our hood. Okay.
But the amazing thing is, even if he doesn't for some reason, through injury, God forbid, or some other reason he doesn't pursue football all the way through pro, with that grade point average, looks like you'll be a success at whatever it does.
All right, everybody gets one quickie before we go to break. Anybody got one ready to go? Got a quickie here?
You don't want me to talk about Phil.
Falcons got a new stadium.
All right, go ahead and give us who's doing the Falcons story.
Falcons Stadium, it's going to happen. Georgia Dome, I don't know if they're going to tear it down. They do a lot of stuff there, but
why would they tear the Georgia Dome?
I don't know.
Because if they build the new stadium would take the place of the Georgia Dome, so it would have to come down.
This features an 8-piece roof that will twist closed. Essentially,
like
an
camera.
Iris.
Right.
It's called the nickname is Sphincter. That's funny.
Stankonia Dome is what they're going to call it.
This looks amazing, though. It's bad for radio, but you have to check this out.
It's one of those designs, buddy, that harkens back to, it reminds you of the main stadium in the China Olympics, in the Olympics were in China. It's something like the bird's nest or something like that.
I just think back about when I went to the All-Star game and the Astrodome was the only dome at the time and saw UCLA Houston play in the Astrodome, and that thing is like an antique now. And here's the Georgia Dome being torn down. What's next? I think we got this thing about we're not going to be happy until we get the Roman Coliseum built.
Well, the thing is, the Georgia Dome is only like 18 years old. It's still a very good sports venue. It never made you feel like you were in a huge stadium, even though you were in a huge stadium. You always felt like you were close to the playing surface. I just don't understand what the need for a new dome is, except to build more luxury boxes, because Arthur Blank gets to keep all that money. That's not revenue he has to share with the other 29 teams in the NFL.
All right, who else has got something?
We got Chad Johnson.
What happened?
Like we
Chad
said,
Johnson,
he was released.
I feel like I'm on TMZ right now.
After 7-0. Are you Harvey or whatever the hell his name is? Chad Johnson released after 7 days of his 30-day stint, buddy. He apparently, quote, "I've learned my lesson," especially over this past 7 days. Yeah. "I think everyone deserves a second chance. Many would say I might not deserve it. I would like to finish my career off the right way." I don't see him playing in the NFL.
I'm not a
ever
Chad Johnson
again.
Fan. He got a bad deal there.
He did. He shouldn't have had to do 7 days.
But I don't think the judge understands the gesture in a locker room antic of patting the guy on the butt.
It was a female judge.
It was a good job. That's the good job pat on the butt. You know.
He needs to get a job in the NFL because he's broke.
Yeah. All right, Tom, we're going to have a minute and a half to do this where we come back in our free-for-all. Go ahead and tell us about
Phil Steele. Phil Steele. Team fits the national championship mold in 2013?
We guessed
he put them through different criteria from last year's record, wins, losses, offensive points per game, returning starters, defensive points per game, turnover ratio, kickers. He put them through 25 different categories, and he came up with the 14 teams that fit the national championship mold. The obvious ones: Alabama, Florida, Florida State, LSU, Michigan,
Texas A&M,
South Carolina, Oregon, Ohio State, Notre Dame.
Is Georgia not on there?
Miami not on there.
South Carolina on there?
South Carolina's on there. Stanford's on there. Here's the three teams that kind of threw me.
Oregon on there?
Oregon. We already said Oregon.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Here's the teams that threw me. North Carolina.
What?
Last time I checked, Phil Steele didn't do basketball.
North Carolina finished 8-4 last year.
It's not happening. They had a good, strong finish, though. I'll say
Florida did a good job. But there's more. University that's located in the great city of Chicago. Northwestern.
Is this academics or is this?
No, no. This is 14 teams that fit the final mold for national championship.
I think he got mixed up.
And lo and behold, there's one. Florida's one. LSU's one. South Carolina's one. There's three SEC schools. No, wait. There's four. Vanderbilt.
Like I said, it must be academics. any poll that no Northwestern and Vanderbilt in it, it's an academic poll.
Phil Steele's
my favorite preseason magazine.
He's got too much information. I can't read it all.
He left out teams like Texas, USC, Louisville, Oklahoma State, and Georgia.
Well, it's a pretty easy thing to do. We could make up 14 teams.
Yeah, Vandy, by the way, 500-1 odds. North Carolina, 300-1. And
Northwestern
150.
By the way, Vanderbilt's going to be pretty good, just so you know.
They're not going to be a national championship team.
Exactly. So, anyway, all right, let's take a break, come back, we'll wrap it up. We'll talk about free-for-all section on shoes and also a quick pick on what we think is going to happen tonight in Game 6 of the NBA Finals right here on Voice of Ocala, Buddy Sports Page.
1370 AM, 96.3 FM, WOCA, The Source.
Hi, this is Buddy Martin. I want to tell you about a conversation I had recently with General Manager Pat Murray on the great family atmosphere at Country Club of Ocala.
It's a family first club. We have any number of different types of memberships, but obviously the one that attracts the greatest level of interest is our family. And the reason for that is we have a little something for everybody. I mean, we obviously have a world-class golf course. We have seven tennis courts here for all levels of tennis players. We have a junior Olympic size swimming pool. We have a fitness center that's second to none. And we have state-of-the-art equipment in our fitness center.
Country Club of Ocala, where the facilities are all a family would ever need. For more information, call today at 352-237-6644. That's 352-237-6644. Country Club of Ocala, proud sponsor of Bundy's Gator Report and Gator Talk Thursday right here on The Source.
Hi, it's Lisa Midget with Kinetic Motion Fitness. I'm looking forward to a fun, healthy summer, and I have a few ideas that might just help you and your friends stay in shape and have fun too. Along with awesome personal training and group classes at our warm and inviting fitness studio, we also offer fitness classes at your home or business. And if you're tired of the same old, boring cake and punch party, why not let us host a hot new health trend, a fitness party at your home or office? If you're having a hard time getting to the gym this summer, because of your crazy schedule, then work out with your friends or coworkers in a private group fitness class or host a fitness party at your home or office. We will bring you and your friends or coworkers one of our great workouts like Zumba, Piloxing, Body Bar, Yoga, Tai Chi, Boot Camp, or Zumbatomics for kids. We can even help you reach your long-term goals by meeting at your place weekly for an on-location workout. Check out our website at kmfocala.com and like us on Facebook. Kinetic Motion Fitness is located just 5 minutes from downtown Ocala near the Skylark Plaza. Kinetic Motion Fitness. We're ready when you are.
This is Don with ABC Frederick's Appliance. Here's my daughter, Lena.
And hey, everybody, it's Lena. You need to come down to ABC Frederick's Appliance on County Road 25, just over the railroad tracks in Bellevue, where you are treated right with the right products like Whirlpool, Maytag, Crosley, and Speed Queen. These are the new ones. Don't forget, we also carry used appliances that we warranty. ABC Frederick's Appliance does repairs, too. Call us at 629-5181. ABC Frederick's Appliance on County Road 25, just over the railroad tracks in Bellevue. It's at 629-5181.
When it comes to medical issues, the big C, cancer, strikes fear in all of us. You know, Ocala is fortunate to have a leading state-of-the-art Florida Regional Cancer Center, and we're additionally fortunate to have their physicians on our airwaves to answer our questions. You know, knowledge is power, and it's yours just for the asking. Tune in next Thursday at 11 a.m. when Dr. Ravik Sandrapathy will be answering your questions. This is information you could use from your friends right here at WOCA The Source and the compassionate physicians at Florida Regional Medical Center.
Hi, this is Brad. I want to take a moment to talk about a serious issue. In the next 5 years, the aviation industry is projected to have a shortage of commercial pilots. Now is the time to start training. Ocala Flying Club has started a scholarship for the youth of Marion County ages 17 to 24. The club will donate up to $4,000 towards a pilot's license. This will help get the student on their way to obtain their commercial pilot license. If this sounds like something you would be interested in, or if you know someone that would be, please contact Ocala Aviation Services, 861-7484.
Stay informed on everything going on in the villages with the Village Spectator newspaper. The Village Spectator is exclusively devoted to the villages with news, commentary, and more. And yes, they have Tom's Picks, a free referral for people who are looking for a company to do work for them. Tom's Picks will refer the company that fits your needs, and all we ask is that you tell them where you heard about them. Call Tom's Picks at 804-1223 and pick up your copy of the Village Spectator today.
Now read Ocala Downtown Newspaper online.
Here we go, round of water cooler lightning picks for the game six tonight. I go first. The Heat bench comes through instead of Green, Neal, Leonard, Miller, Cole, and the Birdman. Where's the Birdman? He needs some energy. And
two games in a row, no Birdman.
I know, because they went small. And stopping Mano will be the key. Who will guard Mano? Because he's now playing much better. So I like the Heat tonight, but it's going to be a battle.
I like the Heat tonight. Don't worry about who's guarding Mano Ginobili. He can't put two games like that together back-to-back. Danny Green will get his. Neal won't get his. LeBron will go for 30. Dwayne Wade shows up. Chris Bosh actually contributes tonight. Heat win easy in game six.
I like the Spurs. That's all I got.
Yeah, I like the Heat to win not only game six, game seven. I like them to win tonight big. So does Vegas, 7 points.
All right, this is about shoes, okay?
I got shoes. I got a pair on right now.
First of all, there's a story about shoes. Apparently LeBron's wearing a pair of shoes to say he's already won a second.
They're being misunderstood. That's not what they're saying.
Well, according to the story, it said Nike either messed up and have to recall the shoes, or it's a signature limited edition that just got ahead of itself.
No,
according to the reports. If it's the first, then obviously Nike is really, really, really going to be rooting for LeBron in the Heat to win over San Antonio. Maybe it's how the NBA championship has and hats and shirts printed for both teams, etc. So you say JJ something else.
That's not the shoes he's wearing.
It's two-time champion on the inside of the shoe.
Right.
The Miami Heat franchise is a two-time champion. When LeBron puts out stuff, people just assume, oh, he's so self-absorbed, it's all about him. No, you're thinking way too...
It's a pair of Miami Heat shoes.
It's a LeBron shoe, but it's, you know, he's on the Miami Heat. They are two-time champions.
Okay, perfectly lead into what I'm going to say. Should players be required to all wear the same kind of shoe? Is it part of the uniform? They can't wear different jerseys. They can't wear different pants. They can't wear, you know, different warm-ups. They have to. Why is it? Because they have deals. They're allowed to have different kinds of shoes.
Money, and if money, this, money, money.
If this, that's still not my question. If this is a Miami Heat shoe, why aren't all the Miami Heat wearing it? Okay? So that's the question. Well, should players be required? Every company can make the same color. They can make different designs. Basically, should they be required to wear the same shoes, okay? And I'm saying yes, okay?
I would say no, because I think that the athletic shoe and the NBA go hand in hand, and these great NBA players have their own specific lines. That helps the NBA. And if everybody's wearing the same thing, people aren't going to go out and buy a new pair of Jordans.
That's not my problem.
I have a totally different take from JJ, but I agree with JJ. The answer is no, and it's the same reason why at Georgia Southern we had to all wear black cleats. But they could be different cleats.
Why is this always about Georgia Southern?
If you hush.
Everything we say is going back to Georgia
Southern. I say
Southern.
No. Never mind. Y'all figured it out.
My goodness.
Never mind. I was going to tell you why, but you're not that important now. Never mind.
That's right. It's not that important. There you go.
I would think more on the side of, like, comfort.
Yes.
Like, everyone has a different style of shoe that they prefer.
All shoes are comfortable
long as
now.
Well, yeah, but as long as they're either... Well, I say if they're all the same color, okay. If not... Because I'll watch basketball games, and I'll see, like, three guys have white sneakers, and also
gold
there's a guy
shoes,
with
pink.
Guys like neon green shoes, and I'm like,
those are cool.
All of a sudden, my eyes don't watch the rest of the players I watched, the guy with the green shoes.
Well, that's the point, is that calling attention to yourself because of the color of your shoe. I don't, you know, if they want to make them all different kind of shapes and models, I had no problem. That'll be at least the same colors, don't you think? What's an orange shoe got to do with a team that's got green outfits? I mean, whatever. Why
Most
is that?
Most of the time they do better at color coordinate. You know where the problem is college. And these sponsors with college like Notre Dame and the Louisvilles with the horrendous shoes, that needs to stop.
Yeah.
Not LeBron with his two-time
so
championship.
So you're agreeing with me. They're a little bit tacky at times.
Yeah, I'm actually saying the teams that wear all the same shoes, sometimes it bites them in the butt, like Notre Dame. That doesn't happen in the NBA.
Yeah, well, the gold shoes seem to be popular now, and that started in the Olympics, if you remember.
Yes.
The finishers aren't wearing the gold shoes. So, anyway, I don't think this should be a fashion statement. They should be similar to what the colors of the team are. That's my take on that. I want to thank you guys today for being on the program, for doing the Around the Water Cooler. Tom is back.
There's breaking news.
You got 10
Sports
seconds.
Illustrated, Patriots are Aaron Hernandez being questioned by police in a homicide investigation.
All right, more on that tomorrow. Thanks to Sean, to JJ. Thanks to Daniel Owen and Dave Pingelor. On behalf of everybody, I'm Buddy Martin. Have a good night, everybody. It's all I've had to be.